atmosphere to go into the Cotton Bowl in Dallas. But it's like a bowl game in the middle of the year.
It means so much to the state of Texas and to the state of Oklahoma. You are being part of history.
So much hostility.
Well, it's a rivalry game. And you better believe both of these teams are going to be a little bit chippy throughout the course of this game.
The competition, you know, it starts in recruiting. It starts in everything you do. And then you're able to take it to the field.
Once the envy of the coaching world, Texas's Charlie Strong, now a leader fighting to maintain control. The beleaguered Strong, he can silence some of those critics with another timely win over his bitter rivals from Oklahoma. We welcome you back to the pregame show brought to you by Wendy's. Rob Stone, Matt Leiner, the coach, Dave Wannstedt with you. Texas, once as high as number 11, now as low as 2-2 with Charlie Strong's job security very much debated out there. But he was in a similar jam leading into the same matchup last year. The burnt orange, they were not only 1-4 and coming off a 43-point loss to TCU, but they were 16-point underdogs to unbeaten in number 10 Oklahoma. The Horns offense, 313 yards. The defense got after Baker Mayfield, sacked him six times, limited the Sooners to just 67 yards on the ground. The result, a 24-17 victory. Strong lifted into the air, put on that golden hat trophy in the high point of a 5-7 bowl-less season. We welcome back Robert Smith from Dallas. Robert, let's talk about determining factors for this one. What is it? Who do you got?
Well, I think it really comes down to turnovers and special teams so often in games like this. And remember, this Texas defense, no interceptions on the year. Oklahoma, only one interception this season. So I think the turnover battle, special teams will be key. We know that Joe Mixon is a big part of special teams, not just as a running back. So I like Oklahoma to take this one 38-28, but I am going to go find a place where I can get some chaps to put on.
Smart move, smart move. I'm going to refrain from ad-libbing on this. Chaps comment. Robert, we'll see you next at halftime.
You know what? Interesting.
Tell me you don't have chaps.
No, no stories. In last year's game, it was a great win for Charlie Strong in Texas. We know that. But Oklahoma went on a seven-game winning streak after this game. So they got it all squared away. When I look at this game, I'm kind of looking at Oklahoma. Can they duplicate what they did last week, 2 weeks in a row, offensively, as far as running the ball, Matt, and throwing the ball, be balanced and playing good defense? Can they put together two good weeks in a row? If they will, I like Oklahoma.
And for Texas, guys, as bad as their defense has been, their defensive line has been pretty good. They've done a great job stopping the run most of the part and getting after quarterbacks. For me, that's the advantage they have in this game, is to attack that young, inexperienced offense line from Oklahoma and create force some errant throws with Baker Mayfield, because he will do that. If they can do that, they'll keep the game close.
These two have split the last 10 meetings. Quickly,
Oklahoma. I like Oklahoma. Let me get my score. 24-14.
I like OU. What do you know? Under 20. 31-21, Oklahoma.
Always a little more offensive. Yes. Always a little more defensive. The 111th edition of the Red River Showdown just about set for kickoff now. Hope you enjoy the beginning of your Super Saturday here on FS1. Gus Johnson, Joel Klatt, they'll have the call from the Cotton Bowl coming up after this.
The house that Doak built, the legendary Cotton Bowl in Dallas, Texas, and we've got one of college football's greatest rivalries as the Texas Longhorns prepare to take on the 20th-ranked Oklahoma Sooners in the Red River Showdown. Texas stumbling into this game. They've lost two straight, most recently 49-31 last week in Stillwater against Oklahoma State. As you take a look at the standings in the Big 12, Baylor top of the table, undefeated. West Virginia right behind them. They'll take on Texas Tech next week in Lubbock, and OU ready to take the field today. Charlie Strong trying to get his young Texas Longhorns mentally focused, especially on the defensive end. Last year proved to be a great day for Texas. We'll see if they can do it today. Hi, everybody. I'm Gus Johnson. Johnson along with my partner Joel Klatt, and welcome to Dallas in the Red River Showdown for Texas coming into this game. Charlie Strong is fighting to save his job.
He sure is. He's pulling out all the stops. Even another demotion of a coordinator. Second straight year early in the season that he's demoted a coordinator. This time, it's his longtime friend and defensive coordinator, Vance Bedford. That's because they've got youth and inconsistency on defense. That shows up in two areas. Missed tackles and big plays. They gave up a number of big plays against Cal and Oklahoma State in their last two losses. But now, the bullseye is squarely on the head coach's back as Charlie Strong takes over for play call duties on the defensive side.
Oklahoma bounced back last week in Fort Worth against TCU. 52-46 winners. And Oklahoma, a team that suffered some early season losses to Houston and to the Ohio State University against TCU last week in a barn burner. They got back to doing what Oklahoma does extremely well.
Run the ball.
That's right.
And they started that with their quarterback, Baker Mayfield. The quarterback design run is what opened up the entire offense for Oklahoma last week against TCU. It's not just his ability as a runner and his athleticism, but it's also the emotional aspect with which Baker Mayfield brings to Oklahoma with the extra shove when he gets into the end zone. That's the type of electricity that gets the rest of the run game going, whether it's Samaje Perine or Joe Mixon or even the passing game down the field to Dede Westbrook.
So after the early losses, OU has turned its focus on winning the Big 12, but they've got to go through Texas first. Last year, Texas winning 24-17 right here on this field. So coming up, one of the great rivalries in the history of the college game. It's the Red River Showdown next on Fox Sports 1.
Is this my car?
State Farm knows that for every one of those moments, there's one of these.
Is this my car?
This is ridiculous!
This is ridiculous! Ah!
From car insurance to car loans, State Farm is here to help life go right.
And welcome back to the 111th Red River Showdown, sponsored by AT&T. Texas OU all set to go. Time now to join the third member of our team on the sideline, Shannon Spake.
Hey there, Gus. You know, there's no denying the electricity in the air down here, and there's no denying the fact that Oklahoma was pushed around in this game 1 year ago. In fact, they got a visual reminder of that this week as Bob Stoops did something he only does a couple times a season. He showed the entire team clips from last year's Texas game, clips where Texas played tougher. They out-muscled them. Now, I know that this is a very long game, but offensive coordinator Lincoln Riley said the beginning of this game is key. He said, we have to come out strong in this slug. We cannot play from behind the chains, and how they do that could determine whether or not they have bragging rights for a year or if they're looking forward to a long bus ride home.
All right, thank you very much, Shannon. Let's check out the four keys to the game.
Both of these teams have to establish the run game offensively. Texas has a great run game. You wouldn't think of it with this high-flying offense, but they do. And Oklahoma, of course, so potent with Perine and Mixon. And then both defenses have really struggling preventing the big play. They've got to do that today against these explosive offenses and some very fast wide receivers.
All right, Texas won the toss, deferred. Perfect day for football. In the Lone Star State, 67 degrees, the Red River Showdown underway here in Dallas. Joe Mixon, he'll start inside his own 5-yard line, crosses the 15 and gets up to the 18, make it the 19-yard line before being stopped. So coming on the field, Baker Mayfield, here's a kid, Joel, he knows all about this rivalry. He's from Austin, Texas.
And he's already played Texas twice. Now he did it once as a Texas Tech quarterback. He's only started this game one time in his career. He desperately wants to avenge that loss from a year ago. Felt like he didn't play well, like he let his team down. He gets that shot today here in the Cotton Bowl.
So Mayfield coming off a terrific game against TCU, 23 of 30, 274, two touchdowns passing, two touchdowns rushing. First down and 10 of the 18 for OU. Perine, Mixon in the split backfield. And they'll hand it off on first down. Perine with room as he gets to the 25, up to the 27-yard line. Chris Boyd brings him down. So last week, Joel, Texas missing 21 tackles. How do you correct that in a week?
Well, you can't. All you can do is encourage aggressiveness. One thing Charlie Strong is known for is great defensive play through his years as a coordinator at Florida and even the head coach at Louisville.
The clock failed to start. Will the clock operator please reset to 14:50? The clock will start on my signal.
Reggie Smith, your referee, one of the best in the college game.
So what he can do for his young defense today is allow them to play aggressive by allowing them to blitz and pressure. The eagerness of youth needs to work to their advantage rather than their disadvantage like it did a week ago.
Piron gaining 10 yards on first down, first and 10 at the 28.
Will the clock operator please reset to 14:50? The clock will start on the ready for play.
Some cobwebs here in the old Cotton Bowl.
That's
this
right.
Neutral site game. And you know Oklahoma is just itching to go fast with this up-tempo offense.
First down and 10 to the 28. And they'll stay on the ground. Mixon with running room. And Joe Mixon gets to the 31. Puna Ford brings him down. But when this man touches the ball, good things happen for OU.
Oh, he's electric. He's electric in the open field. They love to throw it to him as well as a wide receiver as he motions out of the backfield. Top of your screen, Joe Mixon as a wide receiver.
Gain of 4. Second down and 6. Mayfield, quick strike. He finds his slot receiver. And that's D.D. Westbrook. And Westbrook making people miss as he gets upfield and gains 10 yards. Malik Jefferson, Anthony Wheeler combining on the tackle.
D.D. Westbrook is finally healthy. Now, he played the whole season, but they're saying he's 100% for the first time.
Leads this team in receptions with 25 catches. Mixon. And Mixon gets to the 45, drags the pile forward to the 47.
And you're already seeing an identity starting to be formed in this game by Lincoln Riley, the play caller, wanting to run the ball on first down, and they've been effective so far.
Gain of 1, second down and 5 at the 47. Excuse me, gain of 5. Here's Mayfield. Looking, a wide open receiver, incomplete. Mark Andrews wide open. But Mayfield sailing that ball high.
Gus, quarterbacks can't explain why, but the hardest player to hit is a wide open wide receiver. You just don't see it. The windows, those tight windows, define the throwing spot for you. And when you don't have it, sometimes you just jump at it, get a little too eager, which happened to Mayfield on the last throw.
So this Texas defense with an opportunity to get off the field. Third down and 5 at the 47 for OU. Mayfield looking over the middle and caught. First down Sooners, and they get a bunch to the 35. D.D. Westbrook found a soft spot underneath.
Mayfield actually double clutched this ball. He wanted to throw it in the first window right there, and then he had to pull it down and find the second window, but he throws a strike for the conversion.
And here's Mixon running it straight ahead. These two teams very similar. Both want to play fast, but different philosophies coming from different coaches.
Well, it's lineage. You know, when you're talking about coaching trees, Lincoln Riley, the offensive coordinator for Oklahoma, he comes from the Mike Leach style of air raid, whereas Sterling Gilbert, the offensive coordinator in his first year at Texas, comes from more of the Art Briles spread. So very different philosophies here for both teams.
Second down and 8 at the 33. Mixon, skipping, looking, and dragged down. Nice open field tackle by Anthony Wheeler. He's a sophomore from Skyline High School in Dallas.
One of 8 sophomores that are starting on this defense. They're so young. on this defense as part of the reason that they've had so many mistakes and inconsistent play. But they're athletic, they're fast, and they've got a great shot to get off the field here.
Opening drive for Oklahoma that started at their own 18, third down and 9 at the 34. They need to go to the Texas 25 for first down. Mixon, the single setback. Mayfield gives it to him, tries to get around the corner, breaks the tackle, spins, and finally corralled and taken down by Malik Jefferson. And here's a sensational sophomore that knows he needs to make some big plays.
One of the most highly recruited players in the country coming out of high school, and Malik Jefferson has put a lot of pressure on himself, saying that he has not played up to standard so far in this young season. And he shows up early on the first third down stop for Texas, forcing a field goal.
So Austin Seibert comes in to attempt a 49-yarder. His career long is 46 at Kansas last year. He's also the punter.
Prior to the expiration of the play clock, Oklahoma calls their first timeout of the half.
And download the new Fox Sports VR mobile app to live stream today's game in virtual reality. It's as if you're watching from a VIP suite in the stadium. Download the app from iTunes or Google Play. No special equipment required. So a great opportunity for Charlie Strong's team to keep this Oklahoma squad either with 3 points or off the scoreboard. Austin Seibert in to attempt a 49-yarder. His career long 46. And he missed it.
What a huge win for Texas and Charlie Strong on defense. First series as he takes over play calling duties, and this kicking game has struggled for Oklahoma. They had the kick that was returned for a touchdown against Houston in their opening week loss. They also missed a field goal on their opening series against Ohio State as Seibert took it up off the upright. Now Texas with a big win. That is a huge emotional lift for a team that was buried under all the rumors that were swirling around Austin, Texas, and this coaching staff during the week.
So now the Texas offense comes on the field for the first time, led by a freshman, Shane Mouchel, from Lamar High School in Arlington, Texas. First down at 10 at the 32. Mouchel firing! Woo! Almost picked off. Micaiah Quick was shot out of a cannon.
Confusion on the outside. Mouchel is expecting a hitch, and Micaiah Quick is the one that ran it for him. That one should have ended up in the burnt orange end zone, the other side of the field.
So Texas catches a break, second and 10 at the 32. And they'll run it. Deontay Foreman, the junior from Texas City, Texas. And they're missing one of their great running backs.
And Shane Mouchel is going to be without Chris Warren, second leading rusher in the Big 12, as this true freshman has played so well, 65%. They've waited so long, Gus, for a starting quarterback at Texas.
Third down and 7. Mouchel on course down the sideline for Burke. In the air and incomplete. Terrific defense. Jordan Thomas bats it out of his hands. And Texas goes 3 and out.
Really good throw from Shane Mouchel. He's going to throw it up high. Burt has a chance, but that's just an exceptional play by Jordan Thomas. That's something that Oklahoma has struggled with all season long, that 50-50 ball scenario down the field, and Thomas gets a big bat away there.
Michael Dixon, the Australian punter, will send it away from the 21-yard line. Joe Mixon, the deep man. And Mixon has it inside his own 15, a 51-yard punt. The Red River Showdown. Texas, OU, a series that dates back to 1900. And here are the Go RV sights and sounds from the Texas State Fair here in Dallas. and the amazing atmosphere at the Cotton Bowl. Partner, I got a problem with you.
What's up?
Where are the corn dogs, man? You're supposed to bring them.
That's right. I am the youngster of the crew. I was supposed to be on the corn dogs.
That's right.
I'm going to run down at halftime.
Okay, that's okay.
I'm going to get them.
I love the effort.
They're delicious.
I love the attitude.
No ketchup, mustard only.
That's right. First down and 10 at the 15 for Oklahoma. Play action, Mayfield. Rolling out of the pocket, throws on the move, and has his receiver on the far side. It's a catch. Once again, D.D. Westbrook, the redshirt senior. And he has been having a terrific season.
You know, one of the things I'm interested in watching is how Charlie Strong is going to change this defense. He's been a four-down type of guy, four defensive linemen his whole career, and they change here from a three-down look to a four-down look. Four defensive linemen, three linebackers to change from the first 3 weeks.
Second down and two at the 23. And they'll hand it off to Mixon. Breaks one tackle. Picks up the first down as he goes down at the 31. Jason Hall, the safety, coming up and making the tackle. What can a coach do when he takes over a defense at the beginning of the week? What kind of major changes can he use to affect his team?
Well, you're seeing one right here, Gus. This 4-3 look. Now they're moving back into a 3-4 look, but schematics are one area.
The reverse, Westbrook bottled up and taken down at the line of scrimmage. Texas ready for that play. Jefferson Wheeler with the tackle.
As Westbrook comes across that right side, what I love from Texas is that everyone was doing their job, staying home. Looks kind of like a reverse, and then the pursuit of the football. We did not see them make tackles like that early in the game against Oklahoma State.
Second and 9 of the 32. Mayfield, play action fake over the middle. Almost picked off. Mark Andrews, the intended receiver. Dylan Haynes just couldn't dig it out of the ground.
Mayfield had to send this ball just higher than he wanted to because of the drop linebacker. That was number 40. Nation Hughes. And because of that, it was too high for Andrews.
Texas looking for their first interception of the season. Third and 9 at the 32. Oklahoma got their first last week against TCU. Mayfield with time underneath. Caught Andrews. And he lost it. Picked up by Texas. Our first turnover of the game, Dylan Haynes. And that's an interception.
Timeout.
Texas with their first pick of the season.
They went right back to Andrews over the middle, and he just couldn't hang on. Dylan Haynes is there for the interception. First of the year for UT.
They start early here at the Red River Showdown from 5 a.m. on the kickoff time. This place filled up. So much enthusiasm and electricity in the stadium. Texas faced with a third down and 9 at the Oklahoma 49. Oklahoma has used two timeouts already. And we have 8:20 to go in the first quarter. Bouchard, play fake, far side, and incomplete. That ball intended for Amani Foreman, the twin brother of Deontay Foreman. And Texas will have to punt.
And there's a lot of contact over there from Micaiah Quick, number 16 in coverage. He did a great job of taking Foreman all the way to the sideline and using the sideline as the extra defender.
So Michael Dixon will punt it away. He's at his own 37. Joe Mixon standing inside the 10. End over end kick. Mixon has it at the 5. A 43-yard punt. Today, it's NLDS Game 2 as the Dodgers battle the Washington Nationals. Your MLB postseason continues today at 4 Eastern
on FS1. Dodgers won last night 4-3.
They got to feel like they dodged a bullet there, because Kershaw didn't pitch his best. Knocked out in the fifth. Still were able to get the win on the road. So the Dodgers looking good so far in the NLDS.
Dramatic win for the Cubs.
Ooh, how about that?
Wow. Against the Giants.
Of course, the way that he celebrated that home run, I thought it was going to be on Waveland, and it just went into the basket. Cubs fans everywhere across the country excited this morning.
First down and 10 at the 6-yard line. Mayfield 4 of 7, all to D.D. Westbrook. And they throw it over the middle. A completion made. Geno Lewis, the redshirt senior, doesn't want to go down. Brandon Jones trying to strip that football.
Geno Lewis, the backup Y position or tight end position to Mark Andrews, who just dropped that ball for the interception on the previous series. So Geno Lewis in right away.
Gain of 12. First down of the 18 for OU. Mayfield looking. Drops it off. Piron, the intended receiver. But Texas bringing a lot of pressure.
Mayfield did a really smart thing there. When you're under duress in the screen game, trying to burn the football is never a bad idea, but you have to do it in a smart fashion towards your intended receiver, not down the field, so that linemen downfield aren't called and you don't get, obviously, the intentional grounding penalty.
Second and 10. Mayfield again with time, steps up in the pocket, delivers a strike at the 31. Terrific throw for Baker Mayfield, and A.D. Miller calls it in for a gain of 13.
I love what A.D. Miller does here on the left side of your screen. As Mayfield starts to scramble out of the pocket, you're going to see Miller come back to his quarterback, break towards the sidelines, and create separation for the first down.
Baker Mayfield, fourth in the Heisman race a season ago. First down, P-Rod. And P-Rod met by Brecklin Hager. He'll gain a couple.
I've seen from this defense and Charlie Strong already more simplicity. You know, he wants to just go let them play. He wants them to line up correctly and let them pursue the football, and they've done a decent job so far.
Second down and 8, Mayfield going through his progressions over the middle.
And Dylan Haynes has his second interception of the game.
Mayfield is furious because you're going to see Geno Lewis, number 5, get knocked down. He just gets hit in the middle of the route. How there's not a penalty flag on the ground, I will not know. Oklahoma should be furious. Absolutely a foul. The benefactor, Dylan Haynes, with his second interception, and Mayfield is livid. I would be as well. Absolutely should have been a call. That should be called back. An Oklahoma ball. What a break for Texas. How did they miss that? That is as plain as day in the middle of the field.
Now they bring in the 18-wheeler, Tyrone Swoops. And Swoops will run the football and get to the Oklahoma 10-yard line. Baker Mayfield still hot and bothered on that OU sideline.
Well, this is a great opportunity for Texas. They have yet to score a point off a turnover all year long. Of course, that was only the third turnover of the year, but they've got to punch this in and start some momentum.
Second down and 8. Swoops now running left. And nothing doing. As Emmanuel Beal comes up and makes the tackle, Oklahoma has given up 31 points off turnovers, the most in the Big 12 this season.
They're playing with some energy right now. After that blatant missed call by the officials on the last interception, now Oklahoma's got a chance to force a kick or at least make Charlie Strong think about it on fourth down here close to the 10-yard line.
They bring Bouchel back in the game. Third down and 8 at the 11.
We're going to have to take a timeout here.
And Texas does take a timeout. 5:29 to go. Texas first quarter. Texas knocking on the door.
Corolla with Toyota Safety Sense Standard. Toyota, let's go places.
So Texas strikes first blood 3-0 here in the first quarter. Now, people affected by severe weather and other disasters need help now. To support those impacted by Hurricane Matthew, text Matthew to 90999 to give $10 to the American Red Cross Hurricane Relief. The Longhorns capitalizing on the second interception of the day by Baker Mayfield to take a 3-0 lead. Joe Mixon allows this one to bounce out of the end zone. And Oklahoma will start from the 25. So a sloppy start so far for OU.
Well, it started with just the miscues, the missed field goal on their opening possession, had to take a timeout. Then Micaiah Quick had a chance to go pick six on the first snap from Texas. Mark Andrews, normally so reliable, he gets hit, coughs it up to Dylan Haynes for a pick, and then the blatant no call from the officials. Should have been pass interference, there's no question. Did not see, by the way, a signal for uncatchable ball. I don't believe it was uncatchable. Should have been a penalty, but OU dodges somewhat of a bullet, only giving up 3 points to Texas. Maybe can provide some momentum for this series.
First down to the 25. Let's see if they get P. Ryan in the mix now. Samaje playing right. And P. Ryan crosses the 30 up to the 33. Samaje P. Ryan coming off a terrific game last week. 98 yards and 2 touchdowns on 17 carries against TCU. Second and 2. P. Ryan again. P. Ryan with the lane. First down and more. Tries to punch his way free and goes down as he crosses the 45. That's a gain of 14.
They said he's finally healthy. Remember, he was battling injuries last year. He had the surgery in the offseason, and now he's finally 100%, and he's starting to show that explosiveness.
First down to 10 at the 47. P. Ryan again. Skipping, looking, dips, and he'll get inside Texas territory. It's a gain of 5 for this young man from Pflugerville, Texas. 5'10", 235.
I love what he was able to do there, Gus. He kind of skips, finds a lane, and then a physical finish at the end.
Second and 5. B-Ryan. And he'll lean forward and be about a yard short of the first down as Gerald Wilbon comes up with the stop for Texas.
You know, I love what Lincoln Riley here, the play caller, is doing, because he's allowing Mayfield to settle down after that emotional interception with the non-call in the last series. What has he done? He's come out and given the ball to his big back, Samaje Perine, every play so far of the series, and allowed Mayfield now to settle in here for a third down opportunity.
Third and 2. Mayfield to throw. Mayfield over the middle and incomplete. Andrews, shaky start for the redshirt sophomore from Scottsdale, Arizona. As he drops that one. But on third and 2, you run the ball well. Why don't you run the football?
I certainly think that they should have. And clearly Andrews is struggling just a little bit. So sure-handed, such a great threat, including on third down. But I completely agree with you, Gus. Samaje Perine had really not been stopped all series. He should have gotten the ball there.
Austin Seibert punting from the 41. Amani Foreman, the deep man. Fair caught at the 15. Tonight, we've got a big rivalry game on Fox at 7 Eastern. The fifth-ranked Washington Huskies, led by quarterback Jake Browning, are in Eugene to take on Royce Freeman and the Oregon Ducks. Then at 10 Eastern on FS1, Arizona takes on 24th-ranked Utah. And it's all streaming live on Fox Sports Go.
I mean, you talk about bad blood. There's serious bad blood here, but that Washington-Oregon game, Washington has lost 12 straight to Oregon, and the Huskies would like nothing else than to make this season even more painful for the Oregon Ducks.
First down and 10 for Texas. Foreman. Texas with only 6 yards of total offense, but the Longhorns lead the game. Jordan Wade plugging up the middle.
I remember Chris Warren is not in this ball game. They're normally a two-back system where Deontay Foreman and Chris Warren are sharing carries. They have not been able to get Deontay Foreman going so far in this run game, and they are missing Chris Warren, a big back, 6'2", 252 pounds.
Second down and 9, they'll run it again with Foreman. They'll pound it forward. Ball loose on the ground. Oklahoma says they have it. And they do. Stephen Parker comes up with the fumble recovery.
It's so hard to tell where Foreman actually loses the ball. It's right away. He's still up. That ball is on the ground. It's loose. Bouchel tries to go and pick it up, but he tries to pick it up, and it squirts away from him, and then Oklahoma with the recovery.
Obo Aronkwo knocking that ball free.
Stephen Parker, for the second straight week, comes up with a huge turnover. He had the interception last week against TCU, but OU, what a huge play defensively, giving themselves a short field like they've done to Texas twice so far.
So Texas turns it over for the first time. 3 turnovers in the first quarter. First down and 10 at the Texas 16 for Oklahoma. Mixon trying to get outside, cuts it inside, breaks a couple of tackles, and is finally taken down at the 5 by Anthony Wheeler.
In space, this guy is so dangerous. I mean, he can make someone miss in a phone booth, but he's also powerful. He's fast, and yet he's also quick. He's got patience and vision. Joe Mixon is an all-around running back, and he is a threat for this Sooner offense.
He gained 10 yards, first and goal at the 6. Mixon remains in the backfield. Mayfield finds him in space. Mixon chopped down inside the 5. Dylan Haynes throws himself under the chariot. Oklahoma knocking on the door.
Dylan Haynes is the lone senior starter on this team, and he is playing huge so far here in this last chance at a Red River Showdown. Senior from Lago Vista, Texas. Second in UT history with 200 career interception return yards coming into this game today, and he has been huge so far.
Second down and goal at the 2. P. Ryan back in. Offset eye. P. Ryan straight ahead. Touchdown Sooners.
We're going to get the double team right here. And movement at that point is what allows P. Ryan to get in. Goal line situations, you've got to win in the trenches. And Oklahoma is able to do that with Alex Dalton and Drew Samia.
Oklahoma 16 for 18 in the red zone this year with 12 touchdowns. And here's Seibert to attempt the extra point. And it's good. Samaje Perine finding success. 7-3 OU.
Where does beer get all its colors? Let's spin the wheel of malt. The more you roast malt, the darker beer gets. Pale malt makes, well, pale beer with a mild honey taste. Next spin, gently roasted malt. That adds caramel color and flavor. One more, dark malt makes dark beer with chocolate or coffee notes. Sam Adams brews 60 beers from dark to light. And the sweet spot in the middle, Boston Lager. For the love of beer.
The Oklahoma offense making good on the turnover as Samaje Perine scores to make it a 7-3 game. As you take a look at the scoring drive, 3 plays, 16 yards.
Set up by that turnover. Now both squads have scored after a turnover. It was just the difference being OU's defense held Texas to that field goal.
So Amani Foreman, the deep man. And Texas will get a chance to return it inside the 5-yard line. Foreman with running room, still on the move as he gets all the way up to the 35. Now let's go to Mike Hill in Los Angeles for a Carl's Jr. and Hardee's game break.
Fellas, this is Hardy. Check out this play in the Pittsburgh, Georgia Tech game. Nathan Peterman, the quarterback, throws back to his offensive lineman, Brian O'Neill, and the 6'6", 290-pound lineman getting it done. 24 yards for the score. Big fella making it happen, putting Pitt up 7-0 in the first. Back to you.
Makes me feel like Dan Marino's about to run out with those uniforms, you know?
That is the throwbacks great. For Pitt.
And the big fella getting a touchdown, man. What a thrill for him.
First down for Texas. Their offense has struggled. Only 8 yards total. Foreman. And he's wrapped up and taken down immediately by Jordan Evans.
Sterling Gilbert, the offensive coordinator for Texas, he's got to find a way to get Shane Buechele. That's Micaiah Quick, who's down on the far side. Junior from Fresno, corner, as he's lined up on the outside of the numbers, number 16, and he gets chopped down right there, right in that left leg. That was Jake Oliver, number 6, who got him right on that left leg. They had the run designed inside. They were also designing a little bullet screen on the outside. That's what we call now. It's been so popular in the last couple of years. Run pass option type of a play. Shane Buechele making the decision.
So Micaiah Quick being looked at.
You know, this is a big deal for OU because their corner spot opposite of Jordan Thomas has been a revolving door, trying to have somebody step up. And Micaiah Quick did so a week ago, really earned that starting gig, and has played well, had that opportunity early in this game. And now they'll have to go back and circle through those revolving doors again. Parrish Cobb has had time over there, a true freshman, number 4. He's been battling an injury. Dakota Austin was the starter a year ago, number 27.
Second down and 11. You get the feeling that Texas, Joel, is going to have to start airing this football out.
Well, they've got to get Buechele worked into this game. They need to get him an easy completion or two.
He's 0-for-4. Low snap handle, Buechele underneath and caught. There's the easy one. First down, Texas. As Colin Johnson grabs it and picks up 14. Kyle Porter comes in at running back. Buechele whips one to the near side. This time it's Lorenzo Joe. I tell you what, this kid's got quick release.
He does, and you see that rhythm now starting to be established. Credit to play caller Sterling Gilbert for getting some easy completions, and now you see the quarterback clearly playing better.
Second down and 5. Buechele again to throw. Looks up top and incomplete. Dorian Leonard, the intended receiver, and a flag on the play. Jordan Thomas defensively for Oklahoma.
Clearly some contact down the field, no question about that. It's also a flag. Back lane at the 26-yard line. Looked like that was dropped by our referee, Reggie Smith.
There are 2 fouls. Pass interference, defense number 7. That's a 15-yard penalty. After the play, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, defense. An additional 15-yard penalty, first down.
So here's the pass interference first. Jordan Thomas, hands clearly on the wide receiver. Pretty easy call for the official. And after Bouchel got rid of it, down around.
Actually, in the backfield.
In the backfield. How is that called?
That's just Obo.
On one player? I don't understand how that's called just on one player. It's probably because he ripped his helmet off, clearly, but two tangoing back there. And that's called on Okoronkwo, and now another short field for Texas. I got to tell you, though, Gus, it's been very shaky officiating so far.
30 yards in penalties against Oklahoma. First down and 10 of the 19 for Texas. Bouchel pumping, looking, steps up in the pocket, wants to run it. Has some room, hits the edge, and tiptoes out of bounds at the 11. Shane Bouchel, very elusive. He ran for 1,800 yards in high school at Lamar. Second and 2 at the 11.
Not his forte, but clearly quick enough to hurt the defense with his feet.
They run it straight ahead. And Kyle Porter stopped by Emmanuel Beal, and that should take us to the end of the first quarter. With the score, Oklahoma 7, Texas 3. Oklahoma up 7-3. Let's quickly go downstairs to Shannon Spake.
Gus McQuaid, quick. He's on the training table right now. The medical staff looking at the medical replay to see exactly what happened, but he is upset. He has ice on that left knee, so he is looking like he's done for the game. Oklahoma with no injury reports, but he is visibly upset that he's not getting back in this game.
All right, thank you very much, Shannon. Texas at the Oklahoma 10-yard line. Third down and 1. Quick. Deontay Foreman in the backfield. Bouchel gives it to him. Foreman, first down, Texas.
Last time they were down in this situation, they tried to go with the 18-wheeler package with Tyrone Swoops and did not have much success. Had to settle for a field goal, so Bouchel staying on the field here.
First down and goal to the 8-yard line. Foreman again, cuts it inside. And he'll be down at the 1. Texas quickly to the line of scrimmage.
He's such a big back at 249 pounds. This is not the spot to get
cute.
An injured player for OU. His teammates holding him up in the end zone. Like maybe it was, yeah, Ahmad Thomas, number 13, who made the tackle. He's going to come out of the game. He went low. Oh, oof.
Looks like he took a knee to the head.
And that is not what OU fans want to hear. Charles Walker, starting defensive lineman, out with concussion today. Will Johnson has been out with those symptoms.
Tay Evans had to retire from playing college football because of his concussions.
Just retired this week.
So a second down and goal at the 1 for Texas. Foreman remains in the backfield. They give it to him straight ahead. Can he get in? Yes, he can. This Texas team looks a lot different than the one we saw on tape last week against Oklahoma State.
No question about it. The energy that they're playing with right now, you can tell they're playing for their coach. They're playing emotional football. Not just the environment, but the situation in Austin has this team geared up, ready to go, and they're showing it today.
Domain comes in to attempt the extra point. And And it's good. Charlie Strong told his guys, hey, you guys go out and play. Just play. Let me handle everything else. It doesn't matter to me anymore.
Get the Ultimate Edition and play 4 days early.
And welcome back. All the stars come out for the Red River Showdown. The Boz, national champion when he was at Oklahoma. VY, Vince Young in 2005. He won it all. How about Emmitt Smith supporting Texas? He went to Florida. And Toby Keith, the country music star, OU fan. And they're all watching a very good game so far, as Texas responds to take a 10-7 lead.
The key for Texas is they've taken advantage of their break so far. That interception, they get 3 points out of it. And then on the last drive, as Vince Young loving what he's watching right now, they were able to take those two penalties and punch them into the end.
And Joe Mixon, they'll take a knee, and Oklahoma will start from the 25. But getting back to Charlie Strong and what he said to his team this week, he said to his players, guys, y'all go out and play. Let me handle everything else. It doesn't matter to me anymore. What's going to be said is going to be said. I say we were in a similar position last year. You guys go handle the business on the field and let us get you coached up.
I wouldn't even say similar. I think a worse position. They were 1-4 coming into this game. Had not played nearly as well as they did in their first couple of weeks, including a win over Notre Dame at home. So Charlie's got a talented team. He's going to fight and claw and scratch to get himself to next season when this team matures and comes of age. But they're playing well today.
First down and 10 at the 25. D.D. Westbrook, the motion man. And a whistle.
Early start there for Oklahoma on the left side of their offensive line. Might have been offside, though, from Texas prior to Oklahoma moving.
False start. Offense, number 72. 5-yard penalty. First down.
So here's where this is going to come. But Malik Jefferson was also coming up to the line of scrimmage. I thought that maybe he was in the neutral zone. He wasn't, and that didn't influence what was going on with the offensive line. 72 is Ben Powers coming into the starting lineup. Last week was his first start against TCU.
So a first and 15 for OU. Mayfield to Westbrook at the 20, 25, 30, and finally wrestled down at the 32-yard line. Jason Hall comes up and makes the tackle from his safety position.
I don't know if there's anyone else left. So great tackle by Jason Hall in the open field against a very fast wide receiver. That's something we did not see a week ago.
Second down and 3 after the 7-yard gain. Now Westbrook cuts it back, tries to spin, goes down. Now that's the kind of open field tackle by Holton Hill that Charlie Strong is looking for.
One-on-one situations in space. Too often we see in college football the head of the defensive player go down. And while he was faked out a little bit, Holton Hill was able to stay up and then get that right hand on the heel and get Westbrook to the ground.
Third down and 2 of the 33. Oklahoma 1-4 on third down conversions. P. Ryan and Mixon in the backfield. Mayfield to P. Ryan. They'll make that Mixon, and Mixon picks up the first down.
Joe Mixon and Samaje Perine in the backfield at the same time present so many problems for the defense because of that cross action like you just saw, where Perine's going right, Mixon's going left. You got to defend both.
First down, Oklahoma. Mayfield to Mixon, and Mixon tripped up in the backfield and goes down. Jason Hall again with the tackle.
And there was a blitz right here from his safety spot. And I love how he keeps it tight and then he gets down and low and goes for the feet of Mixon. Great play by Jason Hall.
1 yard loss, second and 11. Mayfield handing it off to Perine this time, and he's got all sorts of running room. Samaje Perine down at the Texas 35. Chris Boyd had to hop on to tackle him, but it's a gain of 30.
Here's the key block. Right at the spot, number 97, Chris Nelson gets turned, opens up the hole for Perine.
They'll run it again. Perine. Samaje Perine set the FBS single game rushing record with 427 yards on 34 carries and 5 touchdowns against Kansas in 2014.
You know what I loved about that game? He didn't go for like 301. He went basically two bills and then two bills. It was all day long for Samaje Perine.
So far, 9 carries, 78 yards and a touchdown for Samaje. Second and 6. Mayfield steps up in the pocket. Now scrambles, throws on the move, has his receiver at the 30, Mixon, who gets knocked down at the 24. Joe Mixon.
Elusiveness in tight spaces is such a great trait for a quarterback to have, as we've got a Texas Longhorn player down. That looks like Chris Nelson, the nose tackle, number 97, sophomore from Lakeland, Florida. He's the Big 12's Defensive Player of the Week. It's September 6th.
And you alluded to it moments ago. Charlie Strong, with all these young players on defense, he finally has his quarterback.
Yeah.
He knows that if he can get to next year, if they can be patient enough with him, to get to next year, that this whole situation could turn around.
For Charlie, the problem is not necessarily his record. It's not the fact that he's 2-2. It's the way that they're losing games. The fact that their defense has been ripped through the last couple of weeks, 500 yards in each of those games they've given up.
Cal
with a great quarterback in Davis Webb. Oklahoma State, great quarterback in Mason Rudolph. The problem is everybody's got great quarterbacks. They're still going to see Kenny Hill, who can put up numbers. They've got their quarterback, Shane Buechele. They're seeing Baker Mayfield right now. They've still got Patrick Mahomes in the Big 12. So the fashion in which they're losing is what's angering the base.
Well said. First down and 10 of the 24 for Baker Mayfield, who started his career as a walk-on at Texas Tech. Mayfield handing it off. And Mixon, not a lot of room on that right side. Puna Ford. Texas says they've turned it over.
The run on the field is a fumble recovered by the defense. First down.
No idea where the ball comes out. Certainly looks like it was loose before the knee touched for Joe Mixon.
I think his knee was down.
Boy, that is close, isn't it, Gus?
I think so, but I think his knee was down.
The ruling on the field of a fumble is under further review.
Bruno Ford was the one that was ripping at the ball.
That
last angle was our best angle, there's no question. As Mixon was starting to go down, Puna Ford, the junior from Hilton Head, South Carolina, was ripping at the football as they were going down. Okay, so the left knee for Mixon is what's going to be closest to the ground. Ruling on the field is that this was a fumble. Would have to be indisputable that it's coming loose after the knee in order to overturn this. I don't know if there's enough to overturn that. It's so difficult to tell exactly when the knee goes down and when the ball starts coming loose. Very difficult on that angle. I can't imagine that they would overturn this, with the call on the field being fumble and recovery for the University of Texas. And vice versa, Gus, I don't think they would overturn it if it was ruled down by contact.
Now that could be the third Oklahoma turnover of the first half if the ruling on the field stands.
I just don't see enough for this to be an overturn. It's clearly close. Key being the call on the field was fumble, recovery Texas. Not enough in the replays I saw that would change my mind and award this ball to Oklahoma. Great job by Puna Ford.
But I think the overall point that should be looked at is this Texas defense is playing with a different kind of intensity.
It's no secret that Charlie Strong's players love playing for Charlie Strong. They love this man. You see it when they lift him up on their shoulders after last year's Red River win or the win against Notre Dame in week one. And while he's trying to shelter them from all the criticism and all the noise around the program, it's hard to do.
After further review, the ruling on the field of a fumble is confirmed. First down,
wow.
Texas.
Three turnovers delivered by Charlie Strong's defense in the first half. And the Longhorns have the football again.
Great job by Puna Ford. That's exactly what should happen. Clearly, momentum was stopped. Mixon wasn't going anywhere, and he immediately attacked the football. And this is something they had not done at all, hadn't sniffed turnovers. Only one coming into this game, and already three here in the first half.
So Texas takes over at their own 24. Shane Bouchel found his passing rhythm on the last series. He hands it off to Kyle Porter, going straight ahead. And Porter gets to the 30. Oboe with the tackle.
Really love this story of Kyle Porter, a true freshman from Katy, Texas. Went to four straight state championship games, won two of them, an electric player.
Second down and five, Porter again. This time will be lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage, a swarming Sooner defense led by Capri Doucette.
They're going to have to find a way to rest Deontay Foreman, which is why Kyle Porter was in the game. But now no running backs, empty backfield. It's on Bouchel's shoulder.
Remember, Bouchel, he's got nifty feet. Third down and four at the 30.
Confused, and they have to take a timeout again.
And now OU out of timeouts with 10:25 to go in the second quarter. Some confusion with the Sooners on D.
Since 1922, Dickies has stood for durability and performance. We've earned your trust by making denim that combines strength and comfort to work as hard as you do. And now you'll find more styles, more sizes, and more ways to get the job done. Because every pair wears our name, we back them with an unconditional satisfaction guarantee. Learn more at Dickies.com.
10-7, Texas. Let's go downstairs to Shannon.
Gus, another hit to this Oklahoma secondary. You have Makiah Quick down here on crutches. Ahmad Thomas also on the sideline, helmet off. He went through the concussion protocol and does not look like he's going back in the game. He did, however, go out before this series, addressed his entire unit. So just sticking up for him, giving his guys some last-minute words of encouragement.
All right, thank you very much. Third down and four for Texas at their own 30. Empty backfield for Shane Bouchel. Here's Bouchel, far side, and a first down for UT. Ja'Cory Warren, who last week sat out with a hamstring injury, in the game today, and the senior comes up with a big first down.
They missed him last week, no question about it.
Texas quickly. And it's John Burt with the catch. He'll pick up 1 yard on the play.
Gus, we're in October. You can't call defensive timeouts and be this confused trying to line up to formations in October. You know, this defense, they're just not ready to play again. You know, Mike Stoops, the defensive coordinator, has been around a long time, and certainly he would want his defense to play better and be more ready than they are today.
Second down to nine, Bouchel. Whips one to the near side, and it's caught by Lorenzo Joe again. And Lorenzo Joe getting out of bounds at the 46 for a 6-yard pickup in front of Stephen Parker.
And some of that is all these injuries. You've got 5-6 starters out for Oklahoma, so a lot of backups trying to get their feet wet.
Bouchel tucks it, spins, and gets to midfield, and a first down for Texas. Stephen Parker chops him down.
Good read from Bouchel, and then shows a little athleticism with the spin in order to dive for the first down. Gotta love it.
First down and 10 at midfield for UT. Bouchel sets up, throws a deep ball wide open, and incomplete. Wow. John Burt wide open. And Bouchel just putting too much air under that one.
He had to get rid of that just a hair early before he actually saw Burt down the field. Just misses it because Okoronkwo, the outside linebacker, was right in his face and forcing him to deliver the ball before he wanted to. He knew it. He knew he had the home run ball and missed it.
Second down and 10 at the 50. They'll hand it off to Porter.
So OU secondary has been beaten deep several times, and Texas will try to confuse them again going fast with the tempo here.
Third and 9. Trips at the bottom of your screen. Bouchel looks that way, pumps, and he's sacked for the second time. OU blitzing Matt Romar and Obo combining on the sack.
Okoronkwo is their best pass rusher. There was great coverage down the field, and initially Bouchel had to hold on to the ball because there wasn't anywhere to go with it. Remember, it was third and long, and then Okoronkwo again with the motor, getting to the quarterback, and good pursuit from Oklahoma to force this punt.
Okoronkwo with 2 sacks last week against TCU. Third punt of the day for Dixon. He drives this one to the far side. Mixon will run it and get to the 13-yard line before being stopped. 10-7. Texas playing better defense. Let's see how OU responds offensively when we return. Since 1900, the annual Red River Showdown is one of college football's most storied rivalry games. Since 1929, the game has been held here on the grounds of the Texas State Fair. The pageantry, fanfare, and atmosphere around the matchup are unrivaled. Our Traditions of the Game is sponsored by Dr. Pepper. It's a college football tradition. 10-7, Texas. Oklahoma has had success rushing the football. The combination of Piran and Mixon, 19 carries, 110 yards, and a touchdown. First down at their own 12 for OU. And Piran breaks one tackle, gains a yard on the play. Anthony Wheeler finally brings him to the turf.
Yeah, this defensive front seven has played well so far. You know, Oklahoma has moved the ball, but they've bowed their neck and gotten stops when they've needed to and have not allowed these backs, Piran and Mixon, to get loose. Plus, they've forced some turnovers on this defensive side. They've played excellent today.
Second down and 10. No gain on the last play. Empty backfield from Mayfield. Quick strike on the hitch to the far side. Texas all over that play. Mikel Jones with the reception, but a swarming Texas defense led by Puna Ford.
Puna Ford, Paul Boyette, number 93, a senior, one of the few seniors on the 2-deep, getting the job done. Great pursuit, and they are tackling better than they have all season long. Another third down opportunity here for Texas.
Do they bring the pressure?
They're certainly lined up for it. Man-to-man coverage on the outside. Everybody up near the line of scrimmage.
Third down and 10. Mayfield steps into his throw. He's got a receiver far side. Incomplete. Nick Basquin didn't get a foot in bounds. And Oklahoma will have to punt.
A pass intended for number 83. Nick,
or did he?
He may have been bobbling this as he went down to the ground. Yes, clearly loose as he's out of bounds. Great call by the officials. At first, it looked like a great completion, but no control through going to the ground. And Texas forces another punt. Great coverage on the outside. And Gus, they did heat him up. Charlie Strong starting to get a little aggressive now, getting those old juices flowing as the defensive play caller. An excellent call there, forcing Mayfield to throw it maybe a little before he wanted to.
Charlie Strong, the defensive coordinator when Florida won the national championship with Urban Meyer.
They're going to take a look at this again, but they're going to see what we've already seen, that Nick Basquin, the sophomore from Norman, had possession early, but didn't make an act common to the game. Can't establish him as a runner at that point, which means he has to control the catch through going to the ground. And he clearly was bobbling that when he hit the ground, and it was
after
loose.
After further review, the ruling on the field of an incomplete pass is confirmed. It's fourth down.
Excellent job. Charlie has got it going a little bit, and you can feel the momentum of that defense. They're playing faster, Gus, but I think the main part of what's different with this defense today is they're playing under control. Fast and under control. Charlie's done a heck of a job so far as the defensive play caller.
So Oklahoma will punt it deep in their own territory. Amani Foreman back at his own 45. Texas with a chance to get some good field position. Cyber punting out of his own end zone. Foreman signaling for the fair catch and has it at the 42. A 45-yard punt. Young Shane Bouchel, a freshman, back on the field right after this.
Coming up on the State Farm Halftime, TCU off last week's loss to Oklahoma. They look to avoid another defeat at Kansas. Plus, Hurricane Matthew impacting games and field conditions today. Plus, Robert Smith is going to join us live from the Cotton Bowl to help break down first half. Gus, Joel, we'll see you at the break.
All right, Rob, thank you very much. As Texas takes over at the 42. And they're running with Deontay Foreman. Capri Doucette with the tackle.
Got to establish this run game. You know, as Bouchel has looked good, missed some, hit some big plays, but they're about running the football. Coming out into that play, only 18 rushes for 32 yards. They've got to establish Deontay Foreman here.
Gain of 5 in the last play. Foreman again breaks a tackle, gets to the line of scrimmage, and is knocked backwards. But remember, Foreman suffered an abdominal injury that forced him out of the Oklahoma State game early last week, but practiced all week. Warren is out with a knee injury. He could miss 6 to 8 weeks.
Both of those guys went for 100 yards a week ago, but it's becoming very clear OU is not going to allow them to run the ball, and this is going to be a Shane Bouchel game again in the empty backfield here on a third down.
Third down and 5. Bouchel. And that ball deflected at the line of scrimmage. Looks like Obo got a hand on it again. I tell you what, this kid is playing lights out this year. Okoronkwo.
They were in desperate need of leadership and playmaking on this defensive side when they lost Eric Stryker from last year's defense. And Obo Okoronkwo has stepped up in the biggest moments of last week's game when they needed him most, 2 sacks on the final drive. And he's played big so far here today.
Dixon punts it from the 33, his fourth punt. Joe Mixon back at the 10. And he muffed it. But holds on.
Wow, how lucky is Joe Mixon? It came right back to him.
Three turnovers for Oklahoma in this game.
And I hadn't seen him make a fair catch symbol. Certainly should have with three Texas players right around him. But what a fortunate bounce that it just lit like a, almost like a little dead backspin ball just sat right there for him to pick up.
So Oklahoma coming back on the field. They will start at their own 15-yard line. Mayfield, 11 of 18, 86 yards, no touchdowns, 2 interceptions. And they stay on the ground with Samaje Perine, who tumble forward. Deshaun Elliott comes up with the tackle for UT.
I really like what Bobby Evans is doing, number 71, the right tackle. Playing very well right now. He's just a redshirt freshman, but he's getting a lot of movement at the line of scrimmage.
Second and 1. Mixon. First down. Jordan Elliott brings him down.
this offensive line for Oklahoma has been patchwork during the course of this season. They've been missing Jonathan Alvarez's time. They had Cody Ford hurt. Ben Powers has gotten time, transfer from Butler Community College. Eric Wren, number 58, the center, a walk-on, was awarded a scholarship last Monday before the TCU game.
First down, remember, Oklahoma out of timeouts. 4:20 to go in the first half. Mayfield looking over the middle. Incomplete. Mark Andrews, the intended receiver.
Mark Andrews just doesn't look like himself today. I've seen him get thrown to a few different times. I know that ball was just a little bit high and maybe behind him, but we saw him drop the ball that ended as a wide an interception. Saw him drop another easy one, thrown two, four times, no catches so far today.
Remember, Andrews suffers from type 1 diabetes. Second and 10 at the 29. Mayfield sets up deep in the pocket, fires the deep ball for Westbrook.
Movement of the quarterback, what happens is the backside post route becomes wide open, and when you got a healthy D.D. Westbrook, game over.
Westbrook coming off a career game last week against TCU. Extra point goes, 7 catches, 158 yards and 2 touchdowns. A huge one here. 71 yards. Oklahoma back in business.
UFC 204 starts here. By knockout, by submission, Pickett and Alcantara win any way they choose. UFC 204 prelims tonight at 7 Eastern on FS1.
D.D. Westbrook having another spectacular day in the first half. 7 catches, 121 yards, and a touchdown. And it didn't take OU long to score. 4 plays, 85 yards.
Great design on the play there from Oklahoma, but another big play given up by Texas.
This one deep in the end zone. And Texas will start from the 25. Let's go to Mike Hill for a game break.
As you guys know, the effects of Hurricane Matthew are factoring several games, including the Notre Dame-NC State matchup. 3-0 Wolfpack here. Irish threatening, though. Deshaun Kaiser looking for somebody in the end zone, finds the wrong person. That is Jarius Moorhead of NC State. Low scoring, messy as expected. 3-0 at the half. Gus Joel, back to you.
All right, thank you very much. Remember the big win for Texas this year coming against Notre Dame.
Well, and that's unfortunately for Charlie, one of the factors, you know, of the concern, the base, right, is that great win all of a sudden doesn't look so great anymore because of the struggles of Notre Dame.
Goes down to the 25. Michelle puts it right between the numbers as Hurd, the converted quarterback, having a nice sophomore season.
He's one of these guys that we've seen at quarterback. It's been 6 years that this fan base has waited for a kid like Shane Buechele to be their quarterback, and they finally got him.
Foreman. They make that Buechele running the football, and he picked up the first down.
Remember, since Colt McCoy left, it's been guys like Garrett Gilbert and David Ash. We've had Case McCoy, Tyrone Swoops, Gerard Hurd. Now they've got him. They've got the quarterback that they've so desperately wanted, and they've got to fix all the other areas of their team right now.
Buechele. And he skips that one to Warwick. And is it a catch? No, it isn't.
Pass. It's second down.
It's one of the things when you're going fast as a quarterback in terms of the tempo of your offense and you're just wanting to flip one out as a hitch or something, a lot of times you'll leave it short because you don't get enough on the throw.
Second down. Buechele under pressure. And he'll run it. And get to the 39 as DJ Ward is there to make the tackle for Oklahoma.
Got to give this coverage unit a lot of credit. There's just nowhere to go with the ball. Texas is trying to throw the ball deep down the field. It's their MO. You know, they've only attempted four passes this year over the middle of the field. They either throw it deep or they throw it short on the outside, and Oklahoma is taking advantage of that right now.
Third down and nine. Rochelle scrambling. Steps up on the move. Caught! Nicely done by Colin Johnson, the freshman. And a first down for Texas, gain of 20.
Where they attack, finally the middle on a broken play. And the middle of the field is going to be wide open for Texas because OU is not defending it right now.
Far side, another completion. John Burt. And I like the size of Colin Johnson. He's 6 feet six. 212.
Another one of these talented freshmen. You know, they've got so many inexperienced players. They've played 32 true freshmen last season and this season.
Rochelle steps up. Now bounces it outside and just dumps it out of bounds.
Another Oklahoma player down.
The injuries on this Oklahoma defense.
Four injured player.
It's like Jordan Wade, number 93. He's going to be right in the middle of your screen. And as he's going through, he just gets tripped up and goes down and never was able to get back up.
Maquia Quick has already gone out. Ahmad Thomas has gone out for Oklahoma.
They were already missing coming into today starter Charles Walker, who suffered a concussion in their last game. Will Johnson, an outside linebacker, is out. Tay Evans retired this week, who was a starter at the beginning of the season at the middle linebacker spot due to concussions and the frequency that he was suffering those concussions. So this defense is as thin as it can possibly get.
So Wade walking off on his own.
That's a one spot that they do have some depth, the defensive line. So in for Wade will be number 92, Matt Romar, junior from Port Arthur. Very good player, very experienced player, and a great run stuffer. He comes in at 304 pounds at the nose tackle spot.
And Matt Romar missed nearly the first month of the season due to a concussion. Third down and five at the 38. They run the wildcat with Swoops, and he's close to the first down. I don't know, you can't call, is it a wildcat? Because he rarely throws the ball. Would you
stick with the 18-wheeler. I think that's the way it goes, and they're going to go for it on fourth down here with the 18-wheeler.
This time they hand it to Foreman, and he picks up the first down. Rochelle quickly back in the game. After the 2 yard pickup, first down and 10 at the 32 for Texas. Kyle Porter in the backfield. Play fake. Rochelle fires across the middle. And incomplete. Ball intended for Dorian Leonard, but Jordan Thomas. Another breakup.
This is great defense right here. Great defense. Didn't contact him early, comes in place through the hands of the wide receiver. That's just textbook. What a great play from Jordan Thomas, who was giving up some big plays early in the season, but played great in the last 2 weeks.
Second down and 10. Porter. And a flag on the play. Russ, at the 16-yard line.
This defense is so confused. They're running people on and off the field. They're going to get hit for a substitution here with 12 men on the field. The confusion for Oklahoma right now is it's at an all-time high. Seems like every play they're pointing at each other and trying to communicate late, trying to get lined up. The discussion is whether or not one of the Oklahoma players had an equipment issue.
Illegal substitution, defense, the 12th man did not make it up the field. 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. Repeat second down.
You're going to see the confusion now. The late player, he's going to run on. That's Capri Doucette. They're trying to run a safety off the field. Mike Stoops, normally his entire career has been on the sideline. He went up to the press box for this exact situation. Communication, alignment, substitutions. But it seems like they just continually don't get lined up and are confused on defense.
And the reaction from Coach Stoops. Second down and 5 at the 27 for Texas. 1:37 to go. Bouchel in the corner. And incomplete. John Burt, the intended receiver, and once again, Jordan Thomas covering. He's got a workout in today.
He sure has, and, you know, they're threatening the wrong corner. They're attacking the wrong corner. Jordan Thomas is the one making plays, and Bouchel paid the price. Capri Doucette, number one, comes in and just lays the hammer on the true freshman.
Third down and 5 of the 27. And they'll go with the running game, and a first down for Texas at the 20 is Deontay Foreman. Got enough. Neville Gallimore finally stops him. First down, UT.
Well, you wouldn't say that they've established the run, but they've gotten some critical runs on third down on this series to extend the drive.
From the 21, Bouchel. And some miscommunication on the route that time. Dorian Leonard broke it off.
What a drive now. 13 plays going on 14. Some critical third down conversions. One on fourth down with Swoops in the game as Foreman lunged for a first down. And as we get down close to a minute left in this first half, this is a critical drive to try to take the lead, possibly going in at the half here in the Red River Showdown.
14th play of the drive that started at the 25 for Texas, rather. Here's Bouchel. And Bouchel finds his receiver, and it's DuVernay. And he'll pick up the first down.
Great run after the catch. Knows where the sticks are. He was decisive and got right there.
First down and goal to the 9. And that went incomplete. Texas going at warp speed on offense.
And they had him. There was only one Oklahoma defender out there with 2 Texas wide receivers. Again, more confusion. One corner out there with 2 Texas. And Jordan Thomas blew the play up. What a great job by Jordan Thomas. If he doesn't make that play and that decisive type of move towards a wide receiver, that's going to be 6 points.
Second down and goal of the 9. Pump fake. And another sack, 3rd of the day, as Bouchel goes down. And guess who? Obo Aronquo again. Jordan Wade assisting.
Okoronkwo prevented a touchdown because Foreman's wide open. Armani Foreman is wide open in the end zone. And Bouchel at the last second had to pull that ball down because of the pressure from the outside linebacker, Obo Okoronkwo.
So Texas calls a timeout. They have 1 remaining. And don't forget, the State Farm Halftime Show is coming up with highlights and analysis of this game and lots more from around the country. The Red River Showdown.
Well, on a third down where you really need to take a shot into the end zone, I wouldn't be surprised if they ran a very similar concept like they just did, where they're trying to cross their wide receivers and run an outside wide receiver on some sort of a slant or a post pattern into the end zone.
Let's see if they go away from Jordan Thomas. He's been excellent in this first half defensively for OU.
I was going to attack a corner, I would go after number 9, Jordan Parker. Jordan Parker for Oklahoma is a true freshman from Pittsburgh, California, 4-star recruit, highly recruited from Tennessee, UCLA, USC, Utah was in the mix. But he's in the game because Micaiah Quick had the injury earlier. As a true freshman, you got to put him in the fire as an offense. The only difficulty is that true freshman quarterbacks that don't have the experience, Gus, they don't always recognize those opportunities. They're generally out there just running the offense. So in a timeout scenario, Sterling Gilbert, the offensive coordinator, has got to tell Shane Buechele, hey, we're playing for a matchup here. And they are going to send Armani Foreman, the junior, down to the bottom of your screen, and he's going to work.
Third down goal of the 13. 49 seconds remaining in the first half. Buechele looking, pulls it, wants the run, and goes down at the 10. Reuben Hunter with the tackle. Good defense by Oklahoma.
I love the chess match here because that's exactly where they wanted to go, except they dropped Okoronkwo right into the lap of Foreman, which means that Jordan Parker can play heavy inside leverage and not allow that slant or post pattern. That's exactly where Buechele wanted to go with the ball. Oklahoma knew it. Mike Stoops with a great call to drop his outside linebacker right back into the lap of that route. Bob Stoops has got to be thrilled right there, preventing at least the opportunity for a touchdown as the clock goes down now inside of 5, 4, 3, 2 before Charlie's going to take this timeout.
Texas calls their final timeout of the half. 30 seconds.
Now don't forget to check out Breaking the Huddle with Joel Klatt on Facebook Live every Tuesday at 7:30 Eastern, sponsored by Dr. Pepper. You had Ryan Bosworth and Vince Young on your show yesterday.
Man, what a thrill. You know, for me, first college game I ever attended was at the University of Colorado in 1985. Brian Bosworth was the opponent of Colorado. My dad took me up there. And the greatest player I ever saw on the field was that man, Vince Young. Now, granted, we had to play him twice. That's right, twice. Didn't go well for us. Vince Young was unbelievable.
So Trent Domain comes in, the LSU transfer student. Last week he had about as poor a game as a kicker as you can have. He missed his only field goal attempt and went 1-for-4 on PATs with 3 blocks. This one from 28 yards away. And what a difference a week makes. That was the largest scoring drive of the year for Texas. 18 plays. And it's halftime with the score. Oklahoma 14, Texas 13. Now let's go to Rob Stone in the studio.
All right, Gus, thank you. We welcome.
Welcome back to the Red River Showdown. And we're ready to start the third quarter, 14-13 the score. Texas and Oklahoma. Gus Johnson along with Joel Klatt. And usually in the Big 12, we see a bunch of high-scoring games.
Right.
This game is more of a defensive showdown so far.
It really has been. I think both defenses have played really well. I've loved the way that Texas's defense has responded to the change in play callers. Charlie Strong now taking over the play calling duties for Texas. They were aggressive, and they tackled much better in the first half than we saw a week ago. For Oklahoma, their defense has played well, albeit a little scattered at times, having a hard time getting lined up. For Oklahoma, the theme has been miscues, though. They could have a much larger lead at this point. Miscues on offense in the special teams game. They miss a field goal on their opening series. Had to waste a timeout. In fact, all three of them were fairly wasted. Micaiah Quick had an opportunity for a pick six. Mark Andrews, sure-handed player, drops the ball right into the hands of Dylan Haynes. Then they've got the should-have-been pass interference, wasn't pass interference, interception, and Mixon's fumble. So Oklahoma has shot themselves in the foot here during the course of this first half. They can clean those up, though. And the thing that they can lean on is that they're stopping the run right now of the Texas Longhorns.
All right, Texas won the toss. They deferred, so they'll receive to start the second half. Let's go downstairs to Shannon Spake.
Guys, exactly what Bob Stoops said to me coming out of that locker room. He loves what he's seen on his defense, despite some of those miscommunication moments that we saw. He said, hey, I got a lot of young guys out there. We just have to clean things up. But offensively, he said those miscues are the biggest issue. For Charlie Strong, I like what I see, he told me. I like my defense, the guys that showed up here today. But our Achilles heel has been and is today that deep ball, that big shot. He said, we have got to limit that. We've got to stop it. We got to keep them in front of us.
All right, Shannon, thank you very much. Dede Westbrook with the 71-yard touchdown reception for Oklahoma in the first half as we take a look at the first half stats.
Well, it's those rush yards for Texas. They lean on that run game. Remember, this is a spread that was born via Art Briles and Dino Babers for Stillen Gilbert, the offensive coordinator, and they need that yardage to go way up.
So we start the second half. Texas from their own goal line as they cross the 20. And get up to the 21-yard line. So here comes Bouchel, the freshman quarterback. And Bouchel in that first half, 9 of 21, 79 yards. Your thoughts on his performance?
Well, it's been his least efficient performance of the year so far. But in large part, that's due to the fact that they've been inefficient in the run game. It might be time to try to loosen up the defense with a shot down the field in order to loosen up that front seven of Oklahoma and get the run game going. It could be on seven shoulders here, in particular on the first series. Look for John Burt, speedster, bottom of your screen.
On first down, Longhorns running the football. Foreman breaking tackles, crosses the 35 up to the 37 as Emmanuel Beal and Charles Walker bring him down. A gain of 7. Bouchel to throw on 2nd and 3. He fires deep, and it is incomplete. Hurd was open. Bouchel didn't put enough air under the football, and it gave Will Sunderland time to track it down while it was in the air.
The number one thing you've got to do as a quarterback on the deep ball is anticipate, because if you wait to see him open deep, you're going to underthrow that ball. It's exactly what happened to Shane Bouchel on the last play. Will Sunderland, nice pass breakup in the secondary.
3rd down and 3 at the 28. Foreman breaking tackles, and he picks up the first down. Some power running by Deontay Foreman, who ran for 117 yards against Oklahoma last year, including a game-changing 81-yarder.
And Capri Doucette had a shot there, but unable to get him down. Great run from Foreman to move the chains.
1st down, Foreman again, straight ahead. And Neville Gallimore tackles him from behind.
Gallimore, very good player. Redshirt freshman. They say the sky is the limit for Neville Gallimore, who's very talented on the defensive line.
Play fake. Bouchel up the sideline. Another receiver with a stack. He dropped it in. Touchdown. Devin Duvernay. What a throw. 63.
They're going to attack the corner from the slot and actually run the wheel up the sideline. Jordan Thomas has been great today, but then they throw the switch, cross the wide receivers, and Thomas just hesitated for a moment. And guess who didn't hesitate this time? Bouchel. He threw with anticipation the deep ball, and it was right on the money.
So Texas scores on their opening drive of the second half. 20-14. Bouchel, Duvernay. And we'll stay right here All smiles on that Texas sideline, and you got to smile when you hit a big one like that.
Well, exactly as I was talking about before the series, sometimes you've got to soften up the defense by taking shots. We saw two shots taken from Bouchel right there. Fourth lead change today as these teams are going back and forth in a scene here at the historic Cotton Bowl. They're always in tight matchups. Bob Stoops knows it. His defense without five starters so far today. Ahmad Thomas, Micaiah Quick, Tay Evans, Will Johnson, Charles Walker. Got some backups out there looking to make a play and give up the big touchdown.
Mitchell Becker will kick it off for Texas. Joe Mixon ready to return. And Mixon will bring it out of the end zone. Mixon with that 97-yard kickoff return for a touchdown against Ohio State. Chris Boyd with the tackle on special teams for Texas. So Baker Mayfield comes in the game for the first time here in the second half. He was 12 of 20 in the first half. He threw two interceptions. He threw for 157 yards and did have that long touchdown pass to Dede Westbrook.
You know, human nature is you want to get some of that back and go after them right away with your potent offense, but the exact opposite is true for Oklahoma. They've got to lean on their run game and protect their defense, who's just decimated right now with injuries. Keep them on the sidelines is the goal of Baker Mayfield.
Samaje Perine, 11 carries, 87 yards in the first half. They'll throw it on first down. Mayfield in a tight window. Put that one on the money to A.D. Miller.
Oof. What a great throw from Mayfield. Good anticipation, right on the money. Perine, great block, gave him a little time in the pocket to get that one away.
9-yard pickup, second down and one. Perine, first down, breaks free. At midfield, Perine. And he's down at the 40, and our Dave Wannstedt in the studio, he told us that Bob Stoops needs to go to his OC and say, give that man the ball.
Every coach, and Coach Wannstedt would say this over and over again, don't get bored as a play caller. Make them stop Perine before you go away from it and start throwing the ball.
A 28-yard game, play fake, Mayfield, Westbrook open, again, Dede! 42 yards! This Dede Westbrook, Joel Klatt is something special.
Got that hamstring healthy, and now he shows some great explosiveness. The double move route goes to the slant, then to the go route. And Oklahoma says, hey, we're not getting bored. This is who we are, an explosive offense. What a great series and an answer there from the Sooners.
So the Sooners answer in 58 seconds. The big run by Samaje Perine. And then the 42-yard touchdown. Mayfield to Westbrook. The Red River Showdown starting to get heated here in Dallas. Download the new Fox Sports VR mobile app to live stream today's game in virtual reality. It's as if you're watching from a VIP suite in the stadium. Download the app from iTunes or Google Play. No special equipment required. Three plays, 79 yards. Buckle up, folks. We've had five lead changes in this game, two of them in the last minute.
You get the sense that these offenses are getting warmed up. Quarterbacks getting warmed up, taking shots down the field. Dede Westbrook, the last two games, 15 catches, 321 yards, and four touchdowns. This goes to show you, healthy Dede Westbrook is explosive.
Oklahoma sends it away. And this one in the end zone for a touchback as Foreman will take a knee. What makes this kid so special? What makes him able to come in as a freshman at one of the most storied programs in the history of college football and lead?
Two things. One is his nature, and two is the simplicity of this offense. This offense in its origination was really a high school offense. It's very basic, only a few route concepts, only a few run plays, not a lot of checks at the line of scrimmage. And then his nature, he's poised, he's got a terrific demeanor, he's decisive, he's a gym rat, loves to watch film, and the stage is not too big for him. Remember, Shane Buechele's father, Steve Buechele, was in the big leagues for quite a while. He's a bench coach for the Texas Rangers as we speak. He's been in big environments before.
Foreman really starting to be effective running the football for this Texas team. Matt Romar makes the tackle, but he gained 7 yards on the play.
Physical runs, carrying Sooners for 3-4 yards at a time.
Second down and three. Foreman again. Gobbled up by Obo. I think that's the coolest name, Obo.
Obo Okoronkwo. Here he comes on the blitz. Mike Stoops dials it up, and he comes directly down the heel line. It's the heels of the offensive lineman. Runs right down the line of scrimmage for the tackle.
Third down and two at the 33 for Texas. Quick strike, far side, caught, and a first down as Duvernay, again, who had the big touchdown in the last series, picks up six and a first down.
Will Sunderland out there, he's a backup safety, forced into action. Remember, Ahmad Thomas out right now.
Foreman breaking tackles, flag on the play. Foreman refusing to go down. Deontay Foreman, the junior from Texas City, but Redo set with the tackle.
I think that they're going to get OU for a hands to the face.
Personal foul, hands to the face. Defense, number 14. 15-yard penalty added to the end of the run. First down.
That's Ahmad Thomas.
Number 14, Emmanuel Beal, actually was the culprit. Junior from Reynoldsburg, Ohio. The linebacker just had his hands up. Good call by the official. And again, these penalties really hurt Oklahoma. That's a third 15-yard variety that we've seen today.
First down and 10 at the 41. Only one penalty for Texas as Buechele is nailed in the backfield. Wow, Jordan Evans, Austin Roberts. Fourth sack of the game for OU.
What an amazing job of anticipating the quarterback run. And they just take it right to Buechele. Win at the line of scrimmage, as well as the linebacker. Decisiveness. When you read a play out, you've got to act with decisiveness. That's exactly what Evans was able to do.
Second down and 14 at the 45. Buechele, pump fake, delivers down the field again.
This is just a great catch. Jordan Thomas was right there. And Leonard just stole the ball from him. What great concentration from the junior.
And as you mentioned, Joel Platt. As Domain comes in to attempt the extra point. The Longhorns have found their quarterback. Shane Buechele pitching the rock. Texas back on top. They love their Longhorns. Jordan Spieth, two-time major winner, coming off that great Ryder Cup victory on the sideline for UT. He went to UT, played his college golf career. Second down and 10 at the 15 for Baker Mayfield. Texas with a 27-21 lead. Mayfield, delayed handoff. This time, it's Piran, breaks it inside. Samaje Piran with another huge run. Hager with the tackle, but Piran picks up 22.
And the ability to step out of tackles and break tackles down the field sets up the big run for Samaje Piran.
First down, Piran, 137 yards rushing. They give it to him. He tries to get outside. Not this time. Jason Hall, Anthony Wheeler.
Jason Hall has already had a decent game, coming up with a few open field tackles. He played great last week against Oklahoma State, coming off the bench. Earned himself a start in this game. He led the Longhorns with 8 tackles, 7 of them solo, a couple of quarterback sacks in that game. So he's playing his best football right now.
Second down and 8. Play fake. Mayfield on course. Open again. Bang! Another great throw. Dahu Green. 51-yard gain.
Green's working against Chris Boyd. Mayfield was patient when he just runs right by him. What in the world is Chris Boyd doing, stopping and looking back at the wide receiver? That's just as bad as you can play it at a corner spot.
First and goal, the 9. Piran. Piran doing a lot of downhill running now for OU.
He is just such a physical back. Now, we've seen the elusiveness. He's stepped out of tackles. But the thing I like most about Samaje Piran is once there is inevitable contact, he's the one delivering the contact. He gets low behind his pads, and he's a powerful runner.
5'10", 235. Second and goal at the 4. Mayfield lobs it in the end zone, incomplete. Intended for Geno Lewis. Brings up 3rd down and goal at the 4, but you're running the ball so well with Piran. He's got 2 opportunities. That reminds me of Pete Carroll and Marshawn Lynch in the Super Bowl.
I couldn't agree with you more, Gus. And now Mayfield gets his foot. It looks like stepped on late. Yep, by his left guard. That's Ben Powers, number 72, right on the top of his foot.
3rd down goal at the 4. Mayfield, quarterback draw, tries to get there. Oklahoma. 3rd touchdown in 2 weeks for Baker Mayfield running the football.
We haven't seen a lot of the quarterback design run, but we see it here. Mayfield senses that opening, takes off to his right, and gets into the end zone. Clearly crossed the goal line before that ball came out, so the fact that it's on the ground is a non-factor as the Sooners come right back with a touchdown drive of their own.
27-27 as Austin Seibert tries to give Oklahoma the lead. And he does. The 7th lead change. 4 in the 3rd quarter. A lot of great players and coaches have played a part in this rivalry through the decades, from Earl Campbell and Barry Switzer, Adrian Peterson, and V.Y. Vince Young. Red River Showdown. There's Vince. The Boz. You spent a lot of time with him. What do you have to say about Oklahoma?
He was as intense as anybody about you, and he did not mix words about the fact he's pretty upset about the way that they've been playing, in particular in big moments and big games, Gus.
All right, let's go to Mike Hill for a game break.
Guys, TCU coming off that loss against Oklahoma, having issues against Kansas. The two teams have combined for 8 turnovers after Kenny Hill's 4th of the game. Ryan Willis, who has 3 of his own, capitalizes 21-yard TD run. So the Jayhawks, which hasn't won an FBS game in nearly 2 years, they got the lead right now, 23-14 in the fourth. We'll keep you posted.
Wow. Wow. TCU, not what they have been in the past defensively, but you would think that their offense would play a little better than that on the road at Kansas.
303 yards of total offense and 4 touchdowns in the last 6.5 minutes. Here's Kyle Porter. Cuts it up. And DJ Ward grabs and brings him down after a gain of a few.
Really good defense. You know, one of the great traits for defensive front seven players, if you're a young football player, keep your shoulders parallel to the line of scrimmage. As soon as you turn them, you create seams in the defense. Ward did an excellent job there.
Second down and 8. Rochelle. Sideline. And incomplete. That one in and out of the hands of John Burt.
We've seen some fireworks down the field. I was expecting them today from John Burt. This guy is fast. Has a little bit of space here. Ball is on the money right at the face mask. Got to come up with that catch. Now presents a much more difficult third down opportunity.
Last week against TCU in these situations, third and long, Mike Stoops, the defensive coordinator, brought a lot of pressure.
Brandon Hodges moved a little early.
False start. Offense, number 58. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
Hodges, a junior, 6'4", 310 pounds out at the right tackle spot. Just sits just a hair before that snap comes out and makes this even more of a precarious situation for the true freshman quarterback, Shane Bouchel.
Jake Oliver comes on the field late. Third down and 13 at the 22. Texas needs to go to their own 35 for a first down. Bouchel. Handoff. Porter. And Porter will not get it. Good pursuit by the Oklahoma defense. Neville Gallimore. Oboe, Jordan Evans, all in on the play.
And that front seven continues to play well. That has not been their problem defensively. Their problem is big in giving up those big plays down the field. Their rush defense has been terrific. 36 rushes today for Texas, averaging only 2.3 yards per rush.
To Joe Mixon. Change field position here. Dixon. Mixon with a fair catch at the 24. Every weekday morning, Skip Bayless and Shannon Sharp go head-to-head on the day's hottest sports topic. Undisputed with Skip and Shannon weekdays at 9:30 a.m. Eastern, 6:30 a.m. Pacific, only on FS1. What a third quarter. Our score was 14-13 at halftime. 28-27 now, 20th-ranked Oklahoma with the lead and the football in the Red River Showdown. First down at their own 24. Mixon. They'll crawl forward. Get to the 30. Edwin Freeman grabbed his ankle.
This defense has got to make a play somehow. You know, outside of the turnovers, they have not stopped Oklahoma most of the day. They've got to find a way to get that ball back.
Second and 5. Mayfield to the sideline for Westbrook. Goes up high. And it's a catch. How he kept his foot inbounds. Nobody knows. A 22-yard gain for Didi.
He just held it in that left hand. Pinned it against his shoulder going to the ground.
Mixon.
That was so smart of Oklahoma to get up to the line of scrimmage, because I thought that they would at least take a look at this, but they weren't able to get down in time and stop the game. Gets the foot down, and then the question is, did he control it through the ground? Look at it. He's pinned it against his shoulder, and it looks like he controlled it, but they weren't able to take a look because of the tempo of Oklahoma. That's a smart job by Baker Mayfield right there.
Nine catches, 185 yards for Westbrook. Mayfield looking for him again. He's got it, and he's got speed. Watch out, D.D. Westbrook again. 47 yards, his third touchdown.
Slant right behind him. It clears out. Andrews clears out. Westbrook into the hole behind him.
Extra point is good. D.D. Westbrook putting on a show in the Red River Showdown.
Today, we're talking about automotive awards. Which one of these awards appeals most to you?
Top safety pick, mid-sized car, and SUV.
Most dependable means a lot to me.
The green car, because I like fuel efficiency.
What if there was a car company that received all of these awards?
One company, one award in all these?
Chevy.
Chevy.
Chevrolet is the most awarded car company of the last 2 years.
I love it.
It's fierce.
How would you sum this car up in one word?
Incredible. Amazing. I can't use one word.
Another career day for D.D. Westbrook. 10 catches, 232 yards, 3 touchdowns. Cyber kicking it away to Amani Foreman. And this time, Brandon Jones, one of the return men, will take a knee in the end zone.
Going back to Westbrook, Gus, they were clearly without a number one option on the outside in their week one loss against Houston and even against Ohio State in that loss at home. Mayfield just didn't have a playmaker on the outside. Now, Didi was playing in those games, but he was dealing with a little bit of a muscle strain in his legs. And he wasn't 100%. This is what they expected from D.D. Westbrook. This guy is electric. 10 catches, 232. A few tugs. That's a day at the office right there.
First down, Texas after 25. Bouchard out wide at the 30-yard line, and it's caught by Hurd. Now they call it an incomplete pass.
We've seen Bouchel underthrow a few of those quick patterns on the outside, trying to get them all the way outside the numbers. Just trying to work a little bit too quick at the quarterback spot.
Second and 10. Bouchel looks the other side. Taking his time. Fires it and caught at the 31. Nice catch by Amani Foreman. Offensive line giving Bouchel a lot of time to throw the ball.
Yeah, and he was patient, staying behind the line, not dedicated himself as a runner. And Foreman did a great job of working back to him, giving him a target, because again, you got to create these short yardage situations. And now the 18-wheeler package coming out for the Longhorns.
Tyrone swoops. Third down and 4. Swoops runs it, and he won't get the first down. Questionable call.
Yep.
On third down and 4.
I totally agree. Sterling Gilbert, remember, this is his first opportunity in a Red River showdown. Coming from Tulsa, they hired him in the offseason, first season at Texas. It's a first opportunity for Shane Bouchel in this game. The problem with that 18-wheeler package is they have shown zero ability to throw the ball out of it. And without that threat, the defense can sell out to stop the run as Brandon Hodges, the right tackle, number 58, is the Longhorn down on the ground being attended to after that last snap.
When you think about it, Swoops in his career has thrown for over 3,000 yards and 17 touchdowns. But nowadays, when he comes in the game, you just expect it to be a run, and the defense knows that as well.
And there's only a few runs that they've actually shown. You know, it's either that full quarterback power look where everyone's leading for Tyrone Swoops, in particular over a tackle position, as Hodges is up now on his feet getting helped off the field. Or they're going to run that zone read, which we saw in the last third down. But, you know, I certainly would think that having Bouchel out there with that quick passing game, they've been open on the hitches and some of those out routes, that would have been the better option for Texas there on the last third down.
Dixon punting from the 20, and Joe Mixon is back at his own 25. And mix it with the fair catch.
Oh, he touched it. Loose. Texas has it. Wow.
As the ball was muffed by the receiving team and recovered by the kickers. Because it was still a kick, it may not be advanced. It'll be Texas's ball, first and 10 at the spot of recovery.
What a break for the Longhorn.
I have no idea why Mixon didn't catch this. Based on the shadow, maybe he looked up into the sun or was just misplaying it after signaling for the fair catch. Clearly hit him, and after the recovery, that ball hits him right in the chest, clearly recovered. Great break for Texas again. They've gotten plenty of them during the course of this game. They've got to take advantage of this one. Another short field for their offense.
Chris Boyd with the recovery for UT. And now the Longhorns have it at the Oklahoma 23. Bouchel out wide, and it's caught by Amani Foreman, but a great open field tackle. I tell you what, Jordan Thomas has been a star in the secondary for OU today.
He has been great. Now, he gave up a big play for a touchdown, but he's been terrific on the 50-50 ball down the field. He's got three PBUs, pass breakups, and he's been good in open field tackling as well against Charlie Strong's team.
No gain, second and 10. Foreman breaks it. Foreman still moving and goes down at the 15. Stephen Parker with the tackle for Oklahoma.
Huge third down here. Guess they got to go back to Foreman.
Third down and 2. Foreman, 19 carries, 69 yards. Play fake. Bouchel rolls, looks, fires. Intercepted. Will Sunderland.
Just a little hesitation on the part of Shell. He's open right there, and then Sunderland closes the window as Armani Foreman's got to come back to the ball. They both went down with it. The initial signal is OU, but it's so hard to say exactly what possession.
Is that the defender completed the process of the catch first? It's an interception. First and 10, Oklahoma. The ruling on the field of an interception is under further review.
And this should be an interesting one to watch.
It will, absolutely. I mean, Sunderland, backup safety, sophomore, Midwest City, Oklahoma. He's played in 9 career games. And you see his foreman's got to come back. And Sunderland gets to the ball first, but you feel like they both have some bit of possession. That's going to be so difficult to overturn. Again, call on the field becomes so important. I don't see anything that would change the ruling on the field. The only part here, Gus, as we take a look at a few more of these looks, is that Sunderland's hands don't have contact with the football when they roll over. Now, I don't know if you would have enough to actually award the completion either. If they declare that Sunderland doesn't have possession, I don't think that you could declare that Foreman does have possession in bounds, which would then make it an incompletion. So a lot of things on the table here in this review. A critical review.
This is a big one.
The call on the field, I don't see enough for this to be overturned. At most, if you're going to overturn this call, Gus, the only
After
way is incomplete.
Review, the ruling on the field of an interception stands. First down.
That's exactly what they were thinking in the replay booth. Nothing there to change the call. And a huge break for Oklahoma. Will Sunderland play the game so far? What a crucial interception, as we've seen far too many turnovers from both of these teams so far today. 2 for Texas, 4 for Oklahoma.
First interception of the day for Bouchel. OU with the football, first down and 10. Mayfield handing it off. And they'll get to the 10-yard line as Pirine is stopped by Paul Boyette.
These are the moments when play action pass are so effective, because you can tell the defense, the front seven, they are selling out to stop the run. With Pirine and Mixon in the backfield, this is when you can get loose down the field.
Watch Mark Andrews. And they'll hand it off to Mixon. And Mixon slashing through the Texas defense and picks up the first down. An 8-yard run, first and 10 of the 19. Another run for OU. Pirine still on his feet. Samaje Perine, over 100 yards rushing, 151 to be exact.
And this offense is just churning it out. 530 plus yards of offense. They've snapped the ball 58 times. They've gained 9.2 yards per play in this ball game.
Second and 6. Mayfield to Mixon. Well defended that time by Texas, as Hager and Puna Ford combined on the tackle.
Gotta love what Paul Boyette is able to do. He didn't make the play, but he's in the backfield, and he forces Mixon to jump cut before he wants to, and forces this longer third down scenario.
Third down and 5 at the 24. Empty backfield for Mayfield. He has really good legs. Mayfield steps up in the pocket and runs it, picks up the first down and more, gets to the 40 and out of bounds. 16-yard gain for the quarterback.
Gotta love Eric Wren, 58, the center. Watch his block. He opens it all up. The blitz comes, and he takes it and washes it all the way down to the ground. And then it's like the Red Sea opens up. Mayfield has all sorts of room, man coverage in the back end, and an easy conversion based on the center's block, Eric Wren, senior from Mesquite, Texas.
First down at the 49. Omanahu and Malik Jefferson. No gain for Oklahoma.
This front seven doing a better job so far in this series of stopping the run, but it's been a couple of big conversions from this OU offense, keeping the drive alive. And Mayfield's huddling up right now. This is not about a play. This is the fact that this clock is ticking down. This is all motivation for his unit for the fourth quarter.
End of the third quarter. We've got a good one at the Red River Showdown. Oklahoma and Texas really duking it out. 35-27 OU.
A student athlete dreams of going to college. But for many, that dream can never be realized. Athletic scholarships give many students their only chance to attend college. And they never forget the moment that changed their lives forever. College sports offer invaluable life skills and a permanent network. Meet our newest champions at Big12ChampionsForLife.org.
All right, let's take a look at the scoring by quarters.
Well, that 21 points from Oklahoma, you know, this has just been such an explosive third quarter for Texas as well. I mean, they've hung right in there offensively doing big things, but through three quarters, Texas has given up 554 yards of total offense.
Second down and 10 at the 40. Play fake. Mayfield with a man in his face finds Andrews. He picks up a first down with more room at the 40, 35, 30. Mark Andrews, he's dropped a couple today, but that's a huge 30-yard gain.
And they tricked him with the formation. They had an unbalanced line towards the left, and it looked like he was lined up as the tackle, but he was an eligible player. They're just a man removed from the center position. That's why they ran up to the line of scrimmage quickly, snapped the football, and then got onto the edge.
First down and 10 of the 31. P-Ride downhill running again, and Samaje P-Ride gets inside the 25. Wheeler with the tackle. It's just so interesting. It's like Art Briles is on one sideline, Mike Leach is on the other.
It is, isn't it? I mean, with Lincoln Riley and Sterling Gilbert. Now, one thing that Lincoln Riley has been able to do as the play caller for Oklahoma is incorporate more run game than what we've ever seen from Mike Leach in this true air raid style of offense. He leaned on it late last year to get into the playoff, and he's leaning on it right now here.
Second down and 3. P-Ryan again. And you get the feeling if Mike Leach had a Samaje P-Ryan or Joe Mixon, he may have run the ball a little more.
And you know what? He gets a little bit of a bad rap. Remember, Washington State twice this year has run the ball for over 200 yards, including against Oregon. So if it's there, Mike Leach will run it. He doesn't necessarily want to, but he will.
Third down and 1. P-Ryan straight ahead, and he gets it.
That was all second effort from P-Ryan. They're going to run the power play 72. That's Ben Powers. He's going to come. He gets knocked back into the backfield, but P-Ryan stays on his feet, and then he gets skinny. Watch how he gets skinny, and then he just starts churning his feet to get that extra yard and move the chains.
First down and 10 for Oklahoma at the Texas 20. Mayfield in trouble. Buying time now. Uses his legs. Baker Mayfield out of bounds at the 15. a six-yard gain.
We praised their tackling, speaking of Texas, early in the game. They missed so many tackles, but here, missed opportunities. One Texas player, two Texas players. Paul Boyette, number 93, had a chance at Mayfield and a huge sack to put him off schedule. But Mayfield gets loose and creates a nice second and short. This is a great time for play action to go in the end zone.
Watch D.D. Westbrook. It's been his day. Mayfield go hands it off. P-Rod heading to the end zone. Crashes forward. And goes down at the two. Samaje Perine. A bowling ball. A 10-yard gain. First and goal at the three.
And this is the exact style of drive that their defense needed. A little rest on the sideline. You know that they're going to be threatened by Texas's offense. And they're getting a nice rest here from their offense.
Perine again. Touchdown OU.
Well, Charlie Strong is not used to seeing this. It's good old-fashioned under center from the quarterback. You almost never see that from Oklahoma. You pull the left guard Ben Powers. And get into the end zone. That is smash mouth, downhill, power football.
Extra point good. 42-27 Oklahoma. Sooners with a back-breaking drive.
High school, Dr. Pepper here. You know, as long as I've been in college football, there's been Dr. Pepper flowing through the stands.
Hey, man, dig this. I threw the first Hail Mary pass.
Yeah, out of sight. Hey, fellas, I think there should be a college football playoff. Huh? Settle on the gridiron.
You know, nothing goes better in the stands than Dr. Pepper. And I should know because I invented college football. The whole thing. Whoop, whoop, whoop.
And that's how Dr. Pepper became a college football tradition.
Cool story, bro.
It's a great story.
Let's go, Dr. Pepper here.
High five.
Amen, that too.
Here's some players to keep an eye on for the Nissan Heisman watch. Lamar Jackson, he's been absolutely sensational. Likely the winner if the award was given today, but got a sleeper for you. JT Barrett. You know he's going to be there at the end of the year, likely with an undefeated team facing Michigan. He's going to have those big stages. He's been excellent so far. Deshaun Watson keeping hope alive as an undefeated. And then two guys I want to give some love to, Jake Browning and Mitch Trubisky. They've been sensational for Washington and North Carolina. They deserve a little love for the Heisman as well.
Five Heisman Trophy winners for Oklahoma, two for Texas. This one short, picked up at the 22-yard line, and Texas gets it to the 33 before being knocked out of bounds. Let's go to Mike Hill for a game break.
Fellas, sloppy play in the Notre Dame NC State game, expected with the effects of Hurricane Matthew bearing down. But Ryan Finley just throws this pitch away here on third down. That led to a botched field goal attempt on fourth down. Kyle Bumbard, the kicker, gets gobbled up. Still just 3-3 in the third period of play. Back to you.
That's like backyard, you know, when it's raining, you get your buddies out there, or it's snowing. If you live in a state that's got snow, you get your buddies out there playing in the elements.
First down, Foreman. And he'll get to the 40. Let's go downstairs to Shannon.
Just an injury update on Texas right tackle Brandon Hodges. He has been taken to the locker room, right ankle injury. So they have him in there for observation right now, guys.
Thank you. Second down and three. Foreman again looking for the first down. He has it as he just hops through the hole. Still moving at the 40. Spinning down, and he gets to the Oklahoma 31. 28-yard gain.
When the defense loses their edge and their urgency, missed tackles happen, and you just get the sense OU didn't have that same fire in this series. They come out and miss a few on Foreman.
Now Bouchel to the sideline. And it's caught by the twin, Amonte Foreman.
We saw this last week against TCU. A couple of great series from this OU defense, but then they lost the momentum and TCU came right back.
Texas moving quickly again as the Longhorns pick up the first down. A lot of time left in this game, 10:58, 42-27. You know Texas can move the ball. First and 10 at the 20. Foreman outside with a lane. And Foreman goes down at the 9. Another first down for UT. Jordan Evans stops him.
There's nobody on this side, and then they get inside from the defensive end, inside pressure.
Far side caught. Looking for the end zone. Amati Foreman is there. And Texas strikes quickly.
What a drive from Texas. I mean, right down the field. That was hot knife through butter style of drive. OU put up zero fight on that series, and Texas made them pay. Great run from Foreman. Excellent execution from Bouchel.
Domain in for the extra point. And it's good, but the big question for the Texas Longhorns. Can Charlie Strong's defense stop somebody? We'll see right after this. And welcome back to the legendary Cotton Bowl here in Dallas, Texas. This is one of the great rivalries in the history of college football, the Red River Showdown. Charlie Strong's offense striking quickly, 6 plays, 67 yards. Foreman, Amati with a 10-yard touchdown catch. His twin brother, Deontay, 6 straight 100-yard games. Mixing back deep. And Mixon will get a chance from the 3. Oh, another good special teams tackle by Texas. They have been really doing a terrific job. Deshaun Elliott again on special teams.
He has been flying down the field twice. He got Mixon earlier in the game right below the chin and does it again. Elliott's been tremendous on special teams coverage, and now it's really up to those guys. The offensive line for Oklahoma, 10:30 left. They had a nice long drive on their last possession. This is going to be a heavy dose of run from Oklahoma.
And remember last week against TCU, after a big lead, Oklahoma fell asleep and allowed the Horn Frogs to get back into the game. They swing it out. Mixon. And Mixon taken down by Malik Jefferson.
Really nice play from Malik Jefferson. Some misdirection, faking the run, and then getting the ball on the outside to a very dangerous athlete in Joe Mixon. But Jefferson was not fooled at all. This kid's a terrific player. Freshman All-American honors a year ago. Honorable mention, all Big 12. Big 12 Defensive Freshman of the Year. Terrific talent.
Second down and 9 at the 19 after the 1-yard pickup. He rounds. Texas Tech. Swarming Longhorn defense led by Paul Goyette brings up third down and long.
I would expect Texas to pressure Baker Mayfield here. Charlie Strong with the defensive call. As the crowd comes alive, and Mayfield's going to have to make a play.
D.D. Westbrook, the receiver, at the top of your screen. He's been brilliant. Third down and 8. Mayfield looking, steps up, in trouble, steps back, wide open, caught by his fullback, Dimitri Flowers. And a first down for OU.
Flowers is actually blocking right there, and then he escapes and just finds himself wide open after Mayfield was scrambling around. What an excellent job from Mayfield, keeping himself alive, but then Dimitri Flowers, who was in the protection, finds some open space.
A 15-yard gain in the first down for OU. T-Rock. And he'll get to the 40.
Just seems like every time Texas has two steps forward, they take a step back on third down, and they allow a big conversion and the opportunity for Oklahoma to stay on the field. As looks like
official
Flowers.
Timeout for an injured player.
This is Dimitri Flowers. He's a junior. He's one of their blocking backs. Kind of a fullback guy, chosen as All Big 12 honorable mention last year by the coaches in this league. In fact, talking with the coaches this week, they felt like Dimitri played as good as anyone, as well as anyone, on the offense last week against TCU. Doesn't have to have the football to make an impact. We saw it on the last play. He finds an open spot for a conversion.
When you look at the Oklahoma roster, if you're a Texas fan, you say, what happened? Baker Mayfield's from Austin. Dimitri Flowers is from San Antonio. Samaje Perine is from Pflugerville. Dede Westbrook is from Cameron, Texas.
That's the nature of this state. Over half of FBS recruits, Division I recruits, come from really four states: Texas, Florida, Ohio, and California. There's going to be players from Texas littering the country. This is such a great state for high school football. So passionate about this sport.
Second down and six at the 39. Perine caught in the backfield, leans forward, gets back to the line of scrimmage. Ominahu, first man to him, the sophomore.
Well, here's the next opportunity. They've had this chance before. Oklahoma is 6 of 10 on third down so far today. Mayfield has been excellent. They have not gotten pressure to him. He's had lots of time on third down. Can they get to him here?
Third down and 5. Mayfield has not been sacked in this game. Baker Mayfield, here comes a blitz. Mayfield steps into his throw and has Geno Lewis for another first down.
Just the slide in the pocket. Here comes Texas. They're going to come on the blitz. It looks like he's wide open. A great block from Orlando Brown, who screams down, gets hands on the linebacker, and he's the one that allowed Mayfield to slide out and find Geno Lewis for another third down conversion. They are now 7 of 11 today on third down.
That time, a gain of 14. First down and 10 of the Texas 46. Perine. And he'll pick up 6 yards. Malcolm Roach with the tackle.
Seems like every single time he touches the ball, it's 6 yards. It's exactly what he's been averaging, 6.5 on the day. 28 carries for Perine. 6.6 per, couple of touchdowns. Talk about a workhorse.
190 yards rushing for Samaje Perine. Second and 5 at the 41. Perine brings it inside and first down OU. Boyette with the stop, but that Oklahoma offensive line has just done an excellent job. They've kept Baker Mayfield clean, and they have pushed this Texas front seven rushing the football.
Eric Wren and Ben Powers, I give them a lot of credit. Weren't starters to start the year, 58 and 72, the center and the left guard. Eric Wren was a walk-on, formerly junior college player. Ben Powers, junior college player. They're playing terrific football right now for the Sooners.
First down at the 34. Perine again. Perine down at the 27. Hager with the tackle, but if you notice, now Oklahoma taking their time getting to the line of scrimmage and getting their plays off.
This is what is so advantageous about having an experienced quarterback. You don't have to huddle to go slowly. This is kind of that milk the clock tempo. So what Mayfield's going to do is he won't get his guys all the way up to the line of scrimmage until about 15 on the play clock. It's 16, now 15. Now he'll get them lined up, and he's going to try to make all the checks necessary, and he won't snap the ball until under 5 seconds on the play clock.
5 seconds exactly, P-Ron. And Samaje will gain a yard, maybe a yard and a half. 450 and counting. Is that something that's practiced, Joel?
Absolutely. Situational football, it's so important. And too many times in the college game, you don't see offenses that have the ability to get in four-minute offense. But in four-minute offense, you know you're going to be in third and short. Just by the nature of the play calling, you have to convert these situations and win at the line of scrimmage.
Third down and two. Can someone from the Longhorn defense make a play? Mayfield drops it off. First down, Dimitri Flowers. And right now, this Oklahoma offense just keeping Texas off balance.
And Flowers with his second third down catch of the drive. Now 8 of 12 on third down in this game. Texas just cannot get off the field. Credit the play calling. Also, the first down efficiency of the run game. How many times have we seen third and short rather than third and long for Oklahoma and Lincoln Riley?
12th play of the drive that started at the Oklahoma 18. They've converted three third downs on this drive. First and 10. P-Ron trying to squeeze through the hole.
I mean, they're going old school here, lining up Mayfield from under center. They're running that pulling guard, very similar to what Stanford does. It's called the power play. You pull the guard, you try to lead the guard and the fullback up the hole, kick out the defensive end, and get that linebacker blocked. And now they're going to sit there in this milk the clock mode.
7 minute drive for OU. Second and 7 at the 20. P-Ride again. And a helmet flying off. It's P-Ride, so he'll have to come out of the game. And now Mixon quickly steps on the field.
Well, that's not the guy you want coming out of the game on third and short. He's been so effective for him in that scenario.
Texas
is going to have to call a timeout. The Sooners are taking the air out of the ball in this drive, and it's been Samaje Perine who's been sitting on it.
Aerial coverage is brought to you by DirecTV. If you call yourself a sports fan, you got to get DirecTV. Call 1-800-DIRECTV. The Cotton Bowl. Dallas, Texas, 92,000 plus in attendance for the Red River Showdown, and they have seen a show. 42-34 OU with the lead and the ball, faced with a third down and 3. Joe Mixon in the backfield for Samaje Perine. They run the option. Quick pitch. He lost it. And Mayfield jumps on the ball.
Well, he had all sorts of green grass. Great design as they're going to run a little option play off the defensive end. If Mixon catches the ball, he easily gets the first down. It's right in his hands. Has not played all that great today. Two different punts, one of them recovered by Texas. And this time Mayfield's got to jump on the ball. And we've seen kicking game errors for Oklahoma all season long. 0-for-1 today. First drive of the game ended in a missed field goal. We saw them miss against Ohio State on the opening series off the upright. And we also saw the miss that led to the return touchdown from Houston in week 1.
Texas calls their second timeout of the half. It'll be a full timeout. Will the clock operator please reset the clock to 2:41. 2:41. Thank you.
So with 2:41 remaining in the fourth, Oklahoma prepared to bring on their field goal kicker, Austin Seibert, who missed a 49-yarder in the first half.
And in this huddle, on one side, You're going over all the details for Oklahoma. You're reminding all the offensive linemen just the little details of making sure they step down, seal off the inside gap, try to make sure that the snapper and holder understand, hey, just like any other kick. On the other side, Texas, they're talking about any and all fake possibilities. You just never know in this situation. Got to stay home.
This ball will be spotted at the 29. So a 39-yard field goal attempt by Seibert. And it's good.
Wow.
That one crawling over the crossbar.
Off the upright again. Oh.
You sound like a man who is afraid that I am dead right.
You talk about the Cowboys and the Patriots like they're like your kids.
I do not hate LeBron James. That's the hottest seat in sports media. This is undisputed.
45-34, OU with the lead. Let's take a look at the road ahead for Oklahoma, sponsored by Coors Light, whatever your mountain climb on.
Kansas State, Bob Stoops will face his former boss, Bill Snyder, in that Texas Tech matchup. Sooner fans know the Sooners have been snake bit a little bit down in Lubbock over the years. Stoops is going to use a timeout before a kickoff.
Oklahoma calls their second timeout of the half.
All right, while we'll stay here, let's quickly head to Los Angeles for a game break.
All right, Gus, Kansas and TCU, final seconds. Jayhawks down one. Matthew Wyman, 54-yard field goal attempt for the win. Wide right. So TCU escapes. Kansas still hasn't won an FBS game since November of 2014.
Well, I guess a win's a win.
Yes.
That's what Gary Patterson will tell his club.
On the road.
On the road and in conference. And we were down talking with Gary last week, and he made sure to remind us even before the Oklahoma game, hey, going to Kansas has been tough for us. We've had tough games there. So he was looking ahead to that one even last week before facing these Sooners.
Now Monty Foreman, the deep man line drive kick. They let it go through. It's picked up at the 9-yard line by Foreman. And Foreman turns the corner and gets out of bounds at the 31. So 2:30 to go, fourth quarter. Texas down 45-34 as Shane Buechele comes back on the field.
And this is the guy they've been waiting for so long. Dimitri Flowers on the kickoff team was shaken up just a little bit as he gets helped off the field. But Buechele, he's the man. True freshman. Everyone was hoping he was going to pan out to be a great player, and he has panned out thus far in his career. Now's his time. Two possession game with 2:30 left. Gus, you've got to think of a time on the clock and where you want to score. The strategy here is you got to score with at least a minute left to give yourself a realistic chance for that second possession.
Texas with one timeout. Buechele, they run it. Foreman breaks free, and Foreman gets to midfield. Longhorns will get to the line of scrimmage quickly. Buechele, far side, caught. And it's Johnson, gets the first down. Clock will stop.
We've got a Sooner down. DJ Ward, number 87. Another Sooner down. Boy, this defense is just decimated right now. And we saw this exact strategy from Texas on the last series. They started out with a Foreman run. He got loose against Stoops' defense. And then it was immediately to that outside game. The quick throws to the outside. wide receiver screens, getting easy first downs and easy completions, and it's working so far on this drive as well.
First and 10 at the 40-yard line for Texas.
Wouldn't be surprised to see him go right back to Foreman here.
And they do. Foreman trying to get through the hole and gets to the 35.
The reason that's all of a sudden successful is Oklahoma has scared those deep balls, so they've got their safeties way back and deep. Not enough men up front to stop the run.
Rochelle, pump fake, looks downfield, throws a strike, and they get out of bounds. Nicely done by Jake Oliver.
Oliver read it beautifully. They were trying to get a ball deep down the field as they faked the screen, but Oliver saw that the defense had sunk and just stopped right away.
First down and 10 of the 22. Foreman hits the edge on his feet to the end zone. Touchdown. Just like that, Texas scores. 22 yards.
There is nobody covering this gap. When the defensive end goes inside, there's no linebacker support on the outside. The linebackers get washed up, and Foreman is gone. It's man coverage on the outside. Okoronkwo was the outside linebacker playing at the second level. Wasn't able to get there.
And Texas will go for two. And a timeout call by Oklahoma.
Oklahoma calls their third and final timeout of the game. 30 seconds.
Some nervous moments for Sooner fans and Longhorn fans.
So important here. Minute 45. A lot of time left. Texas still has that one timeout left. But this makes that next possession so critical, because you're either going to just be sitting there with a field goal to tie it, or you're going to have to get all the way into the end zone. It's two-point conversion. These two-point plays, offensively, I'm always a fan of getting the quarterback on the move, getting him outside of the pocket. It gives him a run-pass option, and it forces the defense to flow and choose and declare where they're heading. A lot of times you'll see a throwback to the left side, but they are lined up on the left center of the field. We'll see if they move Bouchel outside of the pocket.
Trips at the bottom of your screen. Bouchel with Kyle Porter in the backfield. Bouchel, play fake, looks in the end zone, incomplete. That one thrown high, intended for Dorian Leonard. 1:45. To play, an onside kick coming up.
Rated M for mature.
Get the Ultimate Edition and play 4 days early.
45-40 OU, a minute and 45 remaining. Onside kick coming up for Texas. The Longhorns do have a timeout. For Trent Domain. Needs to put some English on this football.
That's right. The high hopper. And Oklahoma is going to send their great wide receiver D.D. Westbrook to that far side. They've also got number 5 Geno Lewis, the tight end, over to that side.
There's the kick, and it's covered up. Mark Andrews on the hands team.
Really aggressive from Andrews. Almost like a third baseman in baseball. He didn't allow that football to take a second hop. He went out there and caught it in the air. Excellent job from Mark Andrews. And now offensively, with one timeout for Texas, it's one first down and ball game for the Sooners.
In this game, 1,102 combined yards and 11 touchdowns. And now the Oklahoma fans rising. They are a minute and 44 away. Here's a handoff to Piron. And Piron gets to the 41. Let's take a look at our Dickey's performance of the game, and it goes to D.D. Westbrook.
D.D. Westbrook, 10 catches, 232 yards, 3 touchdowns. Those 232 yards, a Sooner single game record. I couldn't just give it to one guy, Gus. I had to give some love to Samaje Perine as well. This dude was a workhorse today. 34 carries, 211 yards, over 6 a pop. 2 touchdowns. He's been terrific, and a large reason why has been this man. And we've seen him down a couple of times. Dimitri Flowers, number 36, was being attended to.
Texas did not be charged for final timeout. However, Texas declines the option for a 10-second runoff as this injury occurred with a running clock. The clock will start on the snap.
So Texas had called the timeout, but because of the injury,
under 1 minute, there will be no 10-second runoff. The clock will start on the ready for play.
That's right. Reggie Smith just clarifying 10-second subtraction runoff only applies in under a minute. But now Charlie saves that timeout. That's critical, obviously, forcing Oklahoma to make a first down as Dimitri Flowers. I mean, this guy, he's got 2 third down catches and big conversions. He's been so good today. He has left it all on the field in this Red River Showdown.
And I think we did a good job today, partner. We didn't say shootout. We didn't say rivalry.
Texas will not call a timeout. The clock will start on the ready for play.
Well, that's your profession.
You're showing discipline.
You're a professional. Like a great running back. You show great patience.
Too physical for me. This guy's a great running back. It's a Samaje Perine. Second down and 7 at the 41.
Well, that timeout being saved for Texas, that's a big deal. You know, Oklahoma with this running clock now, he'll take it inside of 5 in the game clock, and then it'll be number 32 once more.
Perine.
Texas calls their final timeout of the half.
So with a minute and 10 remaining,
37 seconds.
Texas using their final timeout.
Well, here's the question. At a minute 10, do you go for broke and throw a pass to try to get this first down and end it?
You can't do that.
I don't think you can either. Now, the only caveat to that is getting Mayfield on the outside as a runner with the option to throw it with an obvious open man. It's not necessarily a bad play call. I'm more conservative. I would absolutely run the ball and take my chances, knowing that Texas has no ability to stop the clock, and I would punt the ball, forcing them to go the length of the field.
I think that's a smart move.
Texas's offense just went right down the field in their last two series under a minute and scored touchdowns. Game rests on this play call right here.
Third down and 5 at the 39. A minute and 10 to go. Play fake. Mayfield wants to run it.
A terrible mistake from Mayfield. No reason to fight for extra yardage there. Just got to go down and secure the ball. He is so fortunate. Oklahoma's going to take this delay of game that's about to happen before their punt.
And I believe it was
offense. 5-yard penalty. Fourth down.
And I think it was Bobby Evans, the redshirt freshman, who recovered that football.
You're right. 71. Unbelievable. Texas had an opportunity at it. It went right by number 97, Chris Nelson, who had the real good look at it, just went by his left leg. And Bobby Evans comes up with the ball. Unbelievable.
So Texas with life. As the Oklahoma punt team comes on the field.
Texas has got to sell out to try to block this kick.
As Jerry Garcia would say, the Longhorns need a miracle. Seibert gets it away. And fair caught at the 10. 17 seconds remaining for this young man, Shane Bouchel. No timeouts. He needs a touchdown. How do you do it?
You got to throw the ball down the field, and you've got to go to John Burt at this point. He's your track champion. I think he's the only guy in this situation that can possibly get behind the defense. The safeties for Oklahoma should not be closer than 25 yards at the snap of the ball. There would be no reason for that.
Bouchel in the shotgun. Bounces out of the pocket, throws to the sideline, and incomplete. That one out of bounds. Imani Foreman, closest man to the ball.
John Burt not in the game. So they've got Dorian Leonard, 6'4", 200 pounds. Got Colin Johnson on the field, along with Jake Oliver.
Bouchel steps up, buys time, and runs it out of bounds with 5 seconds to go.
Well, now you got to complete the ball, and you got to start the process of pitching it backwards. This is going to be the lateral game.
Final play of the game. Bouchel with time. Bouchel runs it. Here we go. Looking for a pitch man. Finds Leonard. Leonard throws it to the sideline. They throw it back. Leonard. Keep away. They throw it across the field. Heard, and he's taken down by guess who? Jordan Thomas. And that's it. Oklahoma holds on. 45-40, the final. As the Sooners beat the Longhorns in the Red River Showdown, but there is a flag on the play.
The penalty is declined. The game is over.